Alright, back for another Consummate Opinion.
That was really loud. Really, really loud.
That's how we roll.
Well, that worked out well. I guess it was a little too loud from the get-go, but it is what it is. Okay, so we have Mendel. Obviously, you already heard him. Whiskey... What?
Hola.
Whiskey Puss is back.
Meow.
Gayvid's here.
Hey.
Hey, girl, hey.
Peanut, who's about to break all of her cigarettes in her pocket. And we got a new guest tonight. The Russian.
The silent Russian.
Do you have
Russian.
Anything to say at all? Anything? Anything?
Nasrovia.
I thought that was a Polish thing.
I'm not sure, but that was hot. I've always said the Russian,
Russian
accents were hot.
Huh. Alright, so well, I said I was going to do the Fireball Challenge, so I might as well kick it off with this, and we'll do the What's New With You.
Let's recap. It's been what?
Five, six weeks-ish.
Let's recap. This Fireball Waterfall Challenge.
I don't know where you got the waterfall portion from.
So it's 10 shots.
Well, because
right?
No, it's 4 shots.
It's not just one shot. It's 4 shots. How many is it?
4.
Yeah, it's 4 shots continuously. That'd be a waterfall.
Like what?
Very big shots.
Yeah, they probably are bigger than they're supposed to be. Yeah, this is probably actually like 6 to 8 shots.
The top line says RIP.
Yeah. It's a Halloween.
May or may not die.
It's a Halloween Horror Night special. I need to pregame it with some vodka and Sprite, actually.
Here we go.
Where's that tennis racket? I think I just saw
that whistle. Oh, yeah, we have to talk about that, too.
Jeez.
All right, so the challenge is...
Absolutely.
Joyce here is going to take the 4 shots all at once, and if he fails to do so...
Whiskey Puss gets to slap him with it.
Whiskey Puss gets to slap him, and he has to pull out one nut and hold it like the brain.
No, I'm out.
She doesn't want to see a uni-nut. And then that brainy uni-nut gets slammed with an electric racket that's meant to kill wasps.
Absolutely.
Well, we're going to use that again for like a little trivia deal at some other point.
Yeah. All right, let's get the show on the road.
Hopefully, well, I'm not worried about not being able to do it. I was going to say hopefully I don't stick to it.
Do you have to hold this down?
Yes.
To electrify it?
No. Just press it once and it's all good.
No, the red light needs to be on for sure.
Yeah, I just hit it like 5 times.
No, you gotta hold it.
Is it on? Oh, okay, I see.
Yeah. Here, grab one of your keys and just hold it against it, see if it's working.
Heard that.
Yeah, put the key right on your forehead.
Here, I'll hold it.
And then do it.
You're not touching the thing.
I'm touching.
Oh,
shit.
Your uniball is going to be no.
What's with the uniball? Like, I don't understand.
I don't know, but I like it.
Because you're only going to be showing one nut.
Like, oh, I thought you meant he just had one.
No, I don't have just one.
Like, what's his name? Lance Armstrong?
Lance Armstrong. Does he have any?
Ooh, God,
I don't know.
Hope so, man.
Clearly, he didn't read up on it. Let's go.
All right, so does anyone want to hold this? Anyone?
All right,
hold on.
Might as well hold that.
Hold the mizic. Here we go.
So is he doing the shot with his ball out, or taking his ball out after?
What's the?
You should whip your ball out while you do it.
No,
that'd be hilarious.
No, I have it. No, I don't need the mic.
Of course, he gets the best of the headphones and the mic.
I noticed that too.
Best of both balls.
No, that's
the Russian.
Best of both.
The one ball.
The uniball.
The uniball.
These are the two
ones.
Oh. All right. So we're ready to do this.
Yeah. Are we gonna film it or take pictures?
I will. Oh no, I can't. I will.
I can.
She does not have internet activity on her phone, so that's a good thing. Oh. So you know it won't be posted anyway.
No, it's not. It's got to be posted on the Facebook page.
I'll figure it out.
Yeah, which I'm having trouble, personally.
I
guess. Here we go.
We can put a huge, like, heart over his face so you can't see what
he's doing. Oh, one of those kittens that was hanging off that guy's dick that one time.
Yeah.
I'm starting to get a little nervous.
Clearly. All right,
come on. All
right.
Here we go.
Oh, boy.
drum roll.
Should we not have like a bucket ready for
I
you?
I think you should stand up.
No, because if I can't get touched, I can't get anything.
Yeah, get comfortable. I'm not doing it.
Lay back. Enjoy your shot.
Yeah.
Can we take a picture of just the shot first?
We already got before pictures.
Okay.
So, ready for this?
I'm ready for it. Go right ahead, man. Oh, just don't spew anything in my direction.
Oh, no, I won't.
Fireball and I already broke up a long time ago.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
If you're going to spew,
here we go
to this.
Oh, my God. It's like pure gasoline.
Oh,
wow.
God. That was awesome. You did a really good job.
That was like a champ.
Really not happy about that.
You took it
like a champ.
Yeah.
Like
I'm a swallowing specialist.
That, yeah, exactly.
Obviously.
Swallowing specialist.
So anyway, to get into our topics.
To get into our topics, because you're a swallowing specialist.
Yeah, pretty much.
Are you breathing fire yet? Light a match. Somebody light a match.
Dragon
please.
Breath? All right, so since you handle that so well, the next time I have a fireball challenge, you gotta do two.
No chaser, mind you.
Like heaven burns like hell.
No, you're not gonna do two next time?
Two is not, I don't think it's physically
possible. We have to continue until we break you.
No, I was expecting that to be 10 times funnier than it really was.
Yeah, sorry to let you down.
You're a beast.
You did well.
Wanna start? What's new with you?
What's new with you?
All right, let's start. What's new with you with Mendel?
All right. It's been quite a while. It's been about a month and a half since we did a show, so a lot of crap has happened here. First off, medically, the last time we spoke, I had some sciatic nerve problems happening. Went to the doctor for a few things, and now I'm, like, falling all apart. I got two hernias on my, I guess, lower abdomen area, like, right above my dingus.
You say ovaries?
Ovaries? No, I said I have hernias.
Oh, I heard ovaries.
Of course you did.
That, yes.
No, but I guess for those of you who aren't aware, a hernia is a small rip in your abdominal wall, and sometimes the rip can get large enough to where, like, your guts start to fall out, and that's where you get swelling, like your intestines fall out and shit. So I have two small hernias, plus the sciatic nerve problems. Plus, I have high cholesterol. I'm supposed to be on some kind of diet, but I haven't really started on that diet, especially now that the McRib is out. I had two of them sons of bitches today.
Two.
What?
And
I still haven't had a McRib yet.
Ever?
I've had one before.
Oh, okay.
Since it's been back.
It's glorious.
It's gross.
Hey,
at least now you can say nuts out, guts out.
Wow. What is that from?
I have no idea, but I like it.
That's from Whiskey Puss.
So that's my medical deal. And then, what else? Guar was in town. Myself, a few friends in the Russian went to Guar. We got painted in fake blood and semen and whatnot.
Yeah.
Which I thought...
Sounds like such a blast.
I thought it was... It was tons of fun. I thought it was going to be a problem because here I am at a metal show, like, in the midst of the mosh pit and everything, and I have two hernias and a sciatic nerve situation going on. But it was fine. They gave me some groovy painkillers and... That with
groovy and painkillers fit very well.
That with the alcohol that was involved, I was good to go. Oh, and then you know what else? What else is new with me? Like I said, it's been a while. Like, what, 5 weeks since we did a show? I don't know. I just got a wild hair up my ass one day, and I was looking through the Facebook and the 102.5 page I'm a fan of, and Drew Garabo was, I don't know, he posted something on there, and I just had to post. Okay. I posted... Not a day goes by that I don't wish.
I'm still struggling here. I'm still struggling.
I can hear you wheezing.
I'm still struggling.
Are you about salivating a whole bunch like a dog? Like,
no, it's not that bad. I mean, it's bad enough to where I'm.
You got heartburn?
I'm going to take it over.
Whiskey Puss is going to take the mic over.
I'm sorry.
Specialist. So I posted on Drew Garabo's deal, I posted, you know, not a day goes by that I don't wish Drew Garabo physical and emotional pain. And then I get a whole bunch of people just dogging me for it.
Isn't he, like, such a dick? Like, I don't know who he is, but isn't he such an asshole? You guys love him.
I hate him.
Why?
I don't like
so
him
you're
at all.
Saying it because you're in pain and you don't want him to feel pain? I don't get it.
No. I said I not a day goes by that I wish him physical and emotional pain every day.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And of course, he was the first one to respond. He was like, "I'm so happy that I rent space in your stupid brain."
he is a dick, but I think sometimes he's funny. Billy Madison show's always funny.
Yeah, if you're 13. I don't know, man. I don't like the whole nerd situation.
It's a slow guy.
I don't know anything about him, so.
Neither do I.
And Drew Barabo can fucking...
You're probably not awake when Billy Madison's on.
Absolutely not. I've seen the movie plenty of times. Adam Sandler kills it in it.
But I don't know. I thought it was kind of funny, all the responses I was getting. There was a lot of people that were just hating on me because of that, and I didn't really want to start a thing. I just wanted to get my thoughts out there, but I thought it was kind of funny. And that's it. That's what's new with me.
So now what's new with me?
Yeah.
Oh, what's new with you?
Is it? It feels a little magical in here all of a sudden.
Yeah.
I didn't say it. He said it.
So as you would say, you use the word lady friend. I guess apparently I have a new lady friend in my life. It's not really new. It's been a while.
It's been at least 5 weeks for sure.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Definitely. Actually, I was going to say it last time, but I think I got interrupted.
Sorry. That was me. I'm sorry.
But, yeah, so there's that. Then there's...
No, nobody knows about that. I'm sure they all do, but talk about it.
It's not... What do you want me to talk about?
I don't know. What's her name? What does she do? Where is she?
It's the intern.
Yeah, it's the intern. She's asleep.
I don't mean to put you on the spot. I'm sorry.
No, she's asleep.
After she put you on blast. I don't mean to put you there, but you're there now, so.
She's asleep. We, actually, it's funny. You said magical. We were at Disney the last couple of days. You love it. I know. You love it. I love it. Yeah.
That's what I was going to say. I followed up because you said you were going to the Epcot deal for the food, wine, and food festival.
I went to food and wine like 2 weeks ago.
Good as fuck.
About 2 weeks ago.
And I went, you were there one day, and I was there like the very next day. Like, you were there when, like.
The 6th or 7th.
Friday, and it was on Saturday.
Yeah, it was the 6th or 7th, something like that. It was really good, actually. Really, really good.
And really expensive.
Very expensive.
Did you go with a magical person, Mendez?
Wow. How quickly the tides change.
No, it's still his turn.
Everyone I went with was definitely a magical company because Disney's a place where dreams come true.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like Disney's. Like, I just put a Z at the end of anything. I don't know. I'm stupid.
It's not that.
What?
It's not a big deal. She's just name dropping as she goes by. That's it.
All right. So let's see. What else is new? So other than Disney, went to the Bucks game. First Bucks game of the year.
Of the year?
Yeah. For him.
Well,
for him.
No. Sunday. I went on Sunday.
Oh, you were.
Yeah. I went to Sunday's game.
So you guys were.
Can I get that back?
Okay.
Dave and Whiskey Puss are having to share a mic.
We have to share a mic, and Whiskey Puss really wants it in her hand.
Whiskey Puss
all the time.
That's what she said.
The mic.
The mic.
And that's what he said.
Oh, shit. So both of you guys were looking
at the goal. I was over by the pirate ship.
So was I.
They won their first game then, right?
Second
game. And you know what? Chris and I have become really good friends lately. We've gone to concerts together.
She just keeps name dropping.
It's okay. Not a big deal.
Joyce.
Joyce and I have really good friends.
All right, Russian, we'll talk about this at a later time.
Well, why don't you just, what is Joyce?
When the Gaff and I originally did the show, we had different names. We were all, like, we were just saying different things. And I'm trying to think. Joyce meant, I believe it was justify only yourself.
Ew.
Yeah, I know. It's pretty weak.
Let me guess. DeGaff
picked that name. Hey, DeGaff is talking about making his return.
He better have that fucking freestyle ready by now.
We'll see. Well, he got a new pit bull, apparently, so...
What does that mean, like a girlfriend?
About dogs.
No, a dog, an actual dog.
Oh. I see. Because pit bulls are the devil.
Yeah, it's a blue-nosed pit, too, so yeah, it is the devil.
They eat children, they bite their owner's arms off.
No!
Are you kidding me? What do you mean, no? You haven't heard these news reports?
I know a few blue pits in my life, and they're, like, beautiful dogs, and if you raise them right, they're good as fuck.
I have met...
They're amazing dogs.
I have met huge...
My dog, Gator, is half pit bull.
I have met huge, horrifying to look at pit bulls who are just puppies, and they're awesome. But the news
None
reports
of them
don't
are
lie.
Horrifying to look at. It's how you raise them and whatever you do.
I think
and
it's the owners. I think a lot of
absolutely.
It has to do with the owners.
But you have to also
listen. What they say is their brains are smaller than other dogs, but it doesn't matter if you.
It's not that. It's certain breeds have been bred for certain things. So even
right, but it's not in their DNA. It's how they have all been raised. You don't hear about the great pit bull that saved the grandma crossing the street. You hear about the pit bull that bit the fucking ear off of the other pit bull. I don't know.
No, but I mean, you do get those reports occasionally where a pit bull helps somebody out, like pull somebody.
No, you don't.
No, you do, actually. I mean,
what are you guys reading, Pitbull?
Pull some guy out of a fire or whatever, but I figured he just probably pulled him out of the fire because, you know.
I got
he wanted to go bite his head off?
Because they like it a little rare. They don't want.
Let me save you from this fire so then I can kill you.
No.
Yeah, exactly. Well, pull it out of the oven.
From the fire.
Pull it out of the oven. He's done. He's done.
Do his own thing. He need to be on the headlines, right? No, any dog. You can. Chihuahuas bite ankles all day if it really hurt and killed somebody.
But you have to admit, though, like if you were to compare stories of dogs, pit bulls are just.
Well, of course.
Hellhounds.
We need to have Michael Vick over here and tell us about it.
I really wish he would be here.
I have a Michael Vick jersey.
I would give him a Cody so quick, dude. I fucking despise that guy for the shit.
What do you think would happen if they did a Chihuahua and a pit bull mix?
I don't know if that's possible.
That'd be a very vicious.
Like the pit bull would be
the artificial.
Well, let's see. Wait, the Chihuahua's Mexican, right? So like.
Ay.
Okay. Like, he'd be aggressive because he's pit bull, but he's part Chihuahua, so he'd be too lazy to do anything.
But if they raised him the right way, it'd be fine.
What did you say? I didn't hear something about doing something and then being too lazy. I didn't hear the entire part.
You guys even listening to the conversation?
Gavin,
no,
is
no.
Not,
you're not listening to the dude's story.
I think it's.
Well, Gavin. No, I don't remember ever finishing, but that's fine.
When do you ever?
So the Chihuahua and the pit bull.
Yeah. So no. The only other thing I was gonna say, what's new with me is I got WrestleMania tickets.
Oh, thank God.
Oh yeah. WrestleMania 30 in New Orleans. Oh yeah.
All right. Are the Bella Twins gonna be there?
Of course.
Olay.
Is it around Mardi Gras?
Mardi Gras is in February. This is in the beginning of April, so no.
It ends.
It doesn't last that long. She's doing the math. Carry the one.
A few weeks late, but it's still in New Orleans.
All right, listen, I don't like wrestling. Mendel has got me into wrestling on Monday nights. Not so much, but whatever. But that show they have on E!
The Divas thing?
Yeah. Love them all. I'll go to see them. I don't care. Gavin went to talk.
What's new with you?
Yeah, what's new with you? It's been a long time since you've been here.
Yeah.
Hey, speaking of which, when are we coming out with a Whiskey Puss shirt? Jesus Christ.
Gotta design
that shirt. People want it.
Wow. So what's new with me? Well, it's been a couple months. Things are gearing up for my chorus's show, I guess, is what's really been new with me.
Oh, yeah, you all don't know.
I'm in a gay men's chorus in Tampa. And we rehearse at HCC in Ybor. It's called Una Voce. I'm going to plug the show. Hope you don't care.
Plug it to all like 13 people, so maybe it's
well,
yeah.
Well, then they can go.
Oh, you can double it.
Exactly.
Oh, 26, good.
Yeah, there you go.
We're on our way.
But we're doing a Christmas production called The Wizard of Claws. It's a mashup of Christmas and The Wizard of Oz. I actually play the lion, and I get to sing Thriller, and I'm going to have backup dancers doing the Thriller
dance.
You get
to sing Thriller?
I have a solo doing Thriller.
This guy's good. He can sing very well.
Can we get like a 2-second like preview?
No.
Well, let's like put him on the spot.
That's Smooth Criminal. But,
He said give me the mic.
Would you like the mic?
Give her the mic, dude.
Here you are.
So, Okay, anyway. So, yeah.
We can get
the we really needed, I mean.
So
no, we can do the dance if we really wanted.
If people don't know what Thriller sounds like, no offense to Whiskey Puss, she knows.
Wrong song.
She knows.
Same day.
But you don't need to look it up, Mendel. Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
No, I got it.
No, I don't.
Afterwards.
We're good.
I'm going, dude.
We're good.
I'm going to see you.
We're all going. No, yeah, the whole entire group needs to go and support him.
So I'm down. I'm already going.
We have to get those Whiskey Puss shirts, before we go.
So, yeah.
I'm down.
We're doing performances the weekend of December 13th. So, 13th at Palladium in St. Pete, and Saturday and Sunday, the 14th and 15th, are at HCC Ebor. It's going to be a lot of fun, though, and the script is hysterical. I'll give you a quick little plot thing, is that Dorothy is trying to get back to Oz, gets caught in a snowstorm, ends up in the North Pole. And she thinks all the elves are people from Oz. So,
like Munchkins.
Dorothy's a solid idiot if that's the case.
Because Dorothy lands and she hits her head and she's confused. She's got some head trauma.
I gotcha.
So, I've seen Wicked.
Head trauma.
It really is.
Wicked is amazing. This show's going to be nothing like it.
No, but everybody thinks of The Wizard of Oz, it's going to be completely different. I like it.
It is. Yeah, it's fun, it's gay, and it's very musical. It's very musical. The Wicked Witch of the Tundra, as they call her, is actually going to be a drag queen. So it's going to be funny.
Does she work at Hamburger Mary's?
No, this is actually somebody from the chorus. It's one of the guys getting in drag for it. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah, it's gonna be fun. Other than that, new with me, nothing work. I mow the lawn.
Did you mow Whiskey Puss's lawn?
No, I mowed my own lawn.
she was set on the fact that. No, he does my lawn. He mows my lawn.
I did not mow Joyce's lawn. Are we talking about grass?
Yeah.
No,
okay.
Seriously.
Okay, yeah. I did. Yeah. No.
Woo. Whiskey Puss, I think it's your turn.
My turn.
Whiskey Puss.
Didn't take too long for that.
What's new with you?
Any hoots?
What's new with me? All right. It's been a very, very busy 2 months. I'm just kidding. So, Chris and...
Joyce?
Yeah. I love Matt Joyce. He's a really good baseball player. He really is. No, I really do like Matt Joyce.
I think we should wear name tags.
Please, can I just write it on your foreheads next time?
Hi, my name is Joyce.
So, gone to a few concerts. Luke Bryan with Joyce and...
Peanut
Gallery, yeah.
And the Russian.
Oh, and the Russian. Oh, she loved it. The Russian just... It was like, she thrived.
She couldn't contain herself.
Yeah, she thrived when she saw Luke Bryan come on. I don't think that's the right word, but... It was a really good time. I think Joyce, I, and the intern, we're on like a different level now. First time we came over, it wasn't a good level, but now it's all right. Any hoots.
She's the intern.
The intern and I went to Drake.
No, that's Peanut.
That's a Peanut Gallery. How do you not know your friends?
I'm sorry. I do know their names. I don't know their fake names.
Yeah, I guess that scene, Bria, that blew up in your face really really is hitting you hard.
Why don't you tell them about it?
I was in the garage. I wouldn't know.
Yeah. Oh, the Russian might... Tell them what happened to the wine.
The Russians played in the fifth.
Peanut.
Yeah.
No.
All right. Anyway.
Yeah, your voice is annoying enough.
Anyway, I tried opening a bottle of wine. It fell on my face. Everybody laughed about it. Whatever.
There was no corkscrew.
There wasn't, so I had to use.
So she.
It was a Phillips head screwdriver.
She
right?
improvised.
No, it was a flathead. It was a flathead screwdriver.
Improvised. But you used a little too much finesse instead of just like easing it in.
Yeah, I tried to ease it in.
Oh, really? Okay.
And then it just went all the way home. Yeah. It wasn't fun for me. It was in my eyes.
That's happened to me before.
Yeah.
Yeah, sounds.
I bet it has. That's what he said. Any hoots. So we went to Drake. Great concert. Oh my God. Best concert I've ever been to. Nice. We walked to go see somebody at Hooters.
At Channel 7.
Oh, Lomain. He goes, yeah, just. My phone's dying. He goes.
On the show.
Huh?
We got to get him
absolutely.
On the show.
Yeah, oh, yeah,
he's
most definitely.
Down. He's
most
down.
Definitely.
He goes, oh, you need to come inside and see the black guy. His name's Kat. And I'm like, what the fuck is he talking about?
Oh, Kat, you met Kat?
Yeah.
He's a cool guy.
He said a big black guy. No, he's like
no,
this Kat's little guy in like a coochie fucking shirt and shit. So.
Coochie,
yeah. It's actually a brand. He's like, oh, there was a huge fight that just broke out. And we're like, all
right,
whatever.
It happens all the
walking
time out there,
down
right?
the street. And we see the fight, like, roll out of channel side.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, all right, let's get... Well, no, we know what's going on with this shit, you know? And some guy pulls out a gun. And, like, we're, like, in the line of fire. Like, the guy was standing in front of us, like, 50 feet in front of us in the line of fire.
10.
Whatever, 10 feet.
Peanut says 10 feet.
Obviously,
50 feet, I'm giving it a little bit of a break.
Obviously, one of you guys is more sober than the other.
She was. So I'm like dying. I'm like, oh my God, we're gonna die. Hide behind all these signs and shit. Wrong signs. They're gonna shoot me. If they really wanted to, they could have got me. Horrible. We see the cops rolling down the street. I've never had a gun pointed at my head.
It's not pleasant.
No, it wasn't on my head either. It was just like down the street.
General vicinity, though. I mean, straight bullet could still kill you.
And then we got hammered. Jaeger.
Where at the Hoop? Over Channel Side?
No, he closed it the far
afterwards?
Next door.
Lit.
Yeah, everybody was lit.
Many a night spent it lit.
Yeah, and
nice
what
place.
Willie's we went to, I don't know. Low Main's like showing us around.
Yeah.
I don't know. Anyway, that's what's new with me.
What else have I done?
I don't know. I'm drunk. That's what's new with me. I'm drunk.
All right, so ready to get into current events / not so current events?
Well, I think we should preface this by telling everybody that this is a special installment of the CO show.
I don't know about
this. Yeah. You don't know about what?
I have a feeling it's not going to be all about sex.
Well, of course we're going to probably.
You guys studied,
but
I didn't.
No, nobody studied.
Well,
I
here's the thing. Like,
I didn't study anything for the show.
Because you're... He's a sexpert. He's a sexpert.
Yeah, already now.
Yeah, so the current events and the topics are all about sex or sextually related.
Our sextravaganza.
What'd you say before? Sextacular?
This is going to be a sextacular show, yeah.
Can you just name, like, the top five? Can you just name the top five things you want to call this show? Just make them up. 30 seconds.
It's
going to
be sextacular. A sex extravaganza.
Sex?
Sexcapade.
Sexcapade.
That's good.
Two more.
Sexcape from New York. I don't know.
A boy. Sexy time.
Sex,
yeah.
Excuse me?
Sex in the city? No, I'm just kidding. I don't know.
That was
stupid.
But yeah. So everything's going to be... But no, but yeah. I just pulled a U. Joyce.
The way Joyce is sitting right now.
Out of my leg. It's not like I'm not going to
get her
a nut
shot,
like
dude. She's so far away.
Balls.
Hey, at least somebody's going with the fact that I have more than one. I appreciate that.
Well, because you're supposed to only expose one.
How do you do that?
Why do you only... No.
Just...
No, just show both of them. If you're going to show one, show the brain.
Well, because I figured you only wanted one nut hit by the electric racket.
Go big or go home.
Oh, all right.
He wants the brains.
So next time it's going to be both nuts.
I want you to do this next time.
Absolutely.
Why do you want me to do it?
Because you can. Tell me you can.
I'm not the swallowing specialist. I mean, I will attempt it, but I'm not going to go so far as to say, hey, go ahead and hit me in the balls with an electric racket.
Stomach pump, Little Kim style.
Oh.
Let's
talk about it. All right, so let's get to the current events.
All right, go right ahead.
Hey, the first one's really funny. Fraternity pledge loses testicle in hazing ritual.
Yeah, that's pretty brutal. Like, what happened? How did that...
What?
Yeah, did you read up on it?
No, I... Yes, I did. I read up on it. Jeez, I'm... Man, this is
did
a lot
they
of...
Take
this is a lot of
no,
heat.
No. You know how it's like when you get a tooth that... When you're losing teeth, they, like, tie your tooth to a
to a door. Oh.
No, yeah, with the floss.
Yeah.
Did they tie his balls to floss and shut the door?
No, this is exactly what it said. It said the pledges were hit with towels and shirts.
Oh my God.
That had the ends balled up in knots. And then one of them was struck in the testicles with a towel fashioned as a weapon. He went to the ground clutching his groin. And they finished this hazing by stuffing vinegar-soaked bananas into the mouths of the three men.
Ew.
So basically, this guy, after he was done...
Wait, he had something to say.
What, no, I missed that?
Sounds delicious.
It sounds delicious.
Vinegar-soaked bananas.
So this dude finishes it. He deals with the pain. This guy deals with the pain and ends up having to go to the hospital after, and the testicle was so damaged it had to be removed.
Jesus Christ, man. Well, tell me he got into the frat.
He did.
Right?
He did, but I can't.
If he looks a ball, he better be in that frat house. Better have the biggest room in that frat house.
Yeah, seriously.
That's a problem.
All I'm saying is, what was the weird concealed weapon? Was it a knife? Like, I don't think any other thing.
No,
there were towels, like, you know. Like,
yeah, no, and then there was, like, a thing poking
out. It was balled up at the end. That's all it was. There was nothing poking out. It just hit him, and it basically, like, bursted it.
It bursted it.
Bursted it.
Bursted it. Bursted it.
His ball just burst.
One of them, he lost the test.
He's a uninut. He's a uninutter for sure.
Yeah, he's a uninutter.
Yeah, but where did it go?
Exploded in his sack.
Yeah, right into his body, right?
Yeah, like.
Yeah, no, I get it. Like
half of his sack looked like a deflated balloon.
Like if you feel a sack, like it goes.
Yeah, so like a bag of sand.
Yeah, so there's random sperm floating around everywhere throughout his body.
He's like, oh my God.
So when he sweats, so when he sweats, sperm comes out of his sweat glands.
Are we talking about Little Kim again?
We haven't even talked about Little Kim yet.
No, well, I made mention of Little Kim and swallowing.
Yeah.
She did. Supposedly she had her stomach pumped. And then you mentioned earlier that Alanis Morissette was in the same situation.
Well, that was pre-show.
No, right.
All right, so I got another one for you. And then the next two are exactly about what we're talking about.
Thank God.
Okay. This neck, you'll love this one. And I actually got a joke on you off this one.
Oh, great.
I will love that.
Scorned women expose mistresses on homewrecker website. It's a website called shesahomewrecker.com. What happens is wives and girlfriends find out who the girl who broke them up is, put them online, blast them with city, picture, everything, and just
their
put them on blast.
Everything.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Good. Fuck them.
No.
That's pretty intense. That's really intense.
That is very, very intense, but you should also have a side picture of the guy who's a fucking homewrecker, too, because he probably has one mistress.
Takes two to tango.
Absolutely. And, the guy, he's so great. He's a, nah, I don't give
so a maybe that. We should start a website, theirahomewrecker.com.
Yeah. Hi, I'm a homewrecker. No. Hi, come wreck my home is what we need to start.
For guys who are looking to cheat? Is that what you mean?
Yeah. Because it's totally the guy always. I mean...
No, it's not
always the guy, but...
How many stories have we heard about... I want to get in shape all of a sudden, and then boom, personal trainer banging the girl.
Absolutely. I mean, I've seen it on tons of movies. I don't know.
It's not always the guy, though.
But if you do, hi, let me homewreck your home. Can I come homewreck you? you could totally do a bunch of fucking websites like that, but...
There's one website that's out now. That's
fuck.
Have you guys heard of The Dirty? TheDirty.com?
I've heard of it, but I've never been to it.
You told me about it.
It's pretty sick.
But that's not, like, homewreckers. That's just, like, whores in general, right?
But no, not necessarily, because this guy got his heart broken or whatever,
right.
All of a sudden he's got pictures of this girl, and he just puts them on the dirty and then just lays into her. Doesn't make it true, necessarily.
See, that's so disgusting and degrading that it, like, I can't even handle that.
I can't.
I really can't do it.
So being on websites, I got a great website for you. Let me show it to Whiskey Puss.
For me? All right, go ahead.
I think I've showed you this before.
Home Record website.
Show.
Yes.
Yeah.
You are a bit of a
show, Gavin.
I am a little bit of a home record.
It's called Personals. P-U-R-R. It's a cat lover's.
Oh, I like that.
Social networking.
You been on it, Gavin?
No.
Personals. With kittens. Yeah.
It's for cat lovers. It's perfect. It's for cat lovers. It's cat lovers
meet.com
and get together.
It's like gaychristians.com. Whatever you want.
Blackpeoplemeet.com.
Yes. Blackpeoplemeet.com is the classic commercial.
Personals.
So this is real?
That's real.
He loves kittens.
I do. I love the kitty cats.
I always get so much shit for being
the
dude who has cats.
His name is Gayvid. No, I get shit for being the girl with one cat. And they're like, oh, you're the crazy cat lady. I'm like, bitch, I have a dog now. I don't care. Can't say that. I have this one stray outside my house lately. But whatever. I love cats. People that talk shit have never owned a cat.
Yeah, I agree.
Very, very
I've
true.
I've had cats.
Oh, at your mom's house? Or your
No, I had cats here. When I originally moved here, I did. With
and
the
you,
personals with.
And you still talk shit about cats. I don't get it.
I don't talk shit about them. I'm just, I saw this and I go, this would be perfect for Mendel. This is great.
Yeah. Oh, we already signed you up. It's cool.
Oh,
yeah.
Great.
Your username is Mendel and your password is Puss.
Puss. Because that's what I'm looking for
Puss
on the website.
Boots.
No, not in boots. They'll be like, I'm looking for dudes.
Puss in heels.
Yeah, there we go.
No. All right, so the next current event, and this is where it starts going exactly where we're going with this. Male threesome triggers domestic assault charge.
There we go.
Male threesome.
This is a good topic.
Here we go. Oh, this is right up your alley, dude.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. All right, here we go. Perfect.
Oh, what do you know? And there's three males.
So, after engaging in a threesome with a third male, a Florida couple dealing with trust issues got into a confrontation. Now, here's the thing.
Trust issues.
Yeah, if you have a trust issues, you probably shouldn't
be
engaged in a threesome.
Yeah, in the first place, really.
So this was a male couple
yes.
that had trust issues.
Apparently.
And then they said, hey, let's bring this other guy in, have a threesome. And then it ended up in murder? Is that what you said?
No, just a domestic charge. No murder.
Domestic
no
charge.
Murder, yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, still, yeah. If I think it's like that in any relationship, though, is that if you have trust issues, don't bring a third in.
You really should. I mean, you know what?
Who's to say that one party is not going to be like, I had a really good time with that one. I'm going to go get some more of that, you know, on the side, you know?
True.
I would.
That's true. But I think, honestly, I think threesomes should only be participated in if you're not in a committed relationship. Like, if you're just
right.
beginning to see somebody, you know, where things aren't too serious.
Or if it's just a casual, like a friend with benefits.
Yeah.
Something
because,
like that.
Because if you're already, like, let's say your boyfriend, girlfriend, or boyfriend, whatever, you're in a committed relationship for, like, a good amount of time, and you guys have decided, you know, we're exclusive, and you bring a third party in, that's not always a good look, because if you don't already have trust issues, you're probably going to start to develop them.
Well, gay men as a standard, pretty much. I mean, I feel that we all have trust issues in our community.
In the gay community?
In the gay community. You know, I mean, because you're always looking for... Because
you guys aren't as openly accepted.
We're very promiscuous people.
You know,
there's many people that are in committed long-term relationships.
I think trust issues are everywhere, though.
Yeah, I know. But I think that, you know, gay men also have a higher... A lower level of trust, I should say, because you're always looking
over your shoulder.
Yeah.
Especially when you're in Pasco.
So the guy who...
I'm in Pasco now. I'm scared.
The couple was a 39-year-old. We'll just call him... Well, I mean, it says his name. We're going to post this, so it's not a big deal.
Yeah.
39-year-old Adam Cole and 23-year-old Johnny Anderson. So
Johnny Appleseed. Okay.
So Cole said Anderson became irate and punched a hole in the wall, then tried to keep him from leaving the residence.
Okay.
Anderson subsequently punched Cole's car, denting the vehicle's door and nearby breaking a window. Or nearly breaking window, I'm sorry. Now, Cole said the reason this was is because, Anderson was screaming, I love him, but he cheated on me 3 times and I forgave him.
Jesus, come on now.
But you get in a threesome at that point?
Yeah.
Is that not a smart decision at that point?
It's a terrible decision.
Now, in April, the other guy, Cole, This happened in October. The guy Cole was arrested on felony domestic battery following an argument with Anderson, which was noted as his fiance in the report. Anderson tried to get into the passenger side of Cole's vehicle. Cole drove away while Anderson held onto the car door, being dragged for over 100 feet.
Oh, my God.
This relationship's going somewhere.
Yeah.
Brutal.
Wow.
That's fucking ridiculous, dude.
That really, yeah.
Now we got the last current event happened this month.
Not so current event.
Not so, well that 2 weeks ago, not okay. So current, but woman busted for rough sex with girlfriend. She described herself as a sadomasochist.
Oh, yeah. Puppy likey.
And continued to use a sex toy on her live-in partner after the woman kept telling her to stop.
What was the sex toy?
It was a spiked dildo.
Was it the dildo of death?
Something was hard. It was something hard in sandpaper.
The rambone? You ever seen those dildos that are shaped like fists? Yes.
All it says is a dildo. That's it. And, well...
I was very excited about that.
It was a...
I don't know why.
It was a 23-year-old who was arrested. The girlfriend was 52.
Oh, Jesus. That's why.
Yeah.
She had as many beer hours. Her girlfriend was all crazy.
Which one was the one using the toy?
The younger one.
23-year-old was using on the 52-year-old.
Oh, well, she was probably afraid she was going to break a hip or something.
Not afraid. She was already in pain. She was asking her to stop.
So the younger one, her name was Mia.
Mia.
Mia and the victim had celebrated the birthday, or the older woman's birthday. So the what was her name? It doesn't say her name. Fantastic.
Was it Mia?
52-year-old.
No, the 52-year-old's birthday at a nightclub where they smoked pot and McCarthy used kratom.
They were smoking pot for her glaucoma.
Kratom? I guess it's an opiate. I don't know what it is.
That's new.
For a glaucoma.
Oh.
So when they got home, they engaged in sexual activity. The victim said the girlfriend got rough with her. And she repeatedly used the dildo. It doesn't say anything in particular. So it wasn't a rabbit or anything like that, or a dolphin.
Repeatedly used a dildo? Read on. Like in her butt?
Assaulted her with the dildo, adding that it was the first time a girlfriend got rough with her. She was a sadomasochist.
Ooh, yes.
That the couple enjoys rough sex together, which sometimes leaves marks.
Ooh, yeah.
Was she like smacking her on the head with the dildo?
Just said assaulted her. Slapped her in the face. The classic on the chin deal.
Leaving a mushroom tattoo.
McCarthy said the woman did not use the safe words.
The
safe word.
Blueberry pancakes.
Blueberry pancakes.
And she said that no means yes.
Oh, so she was pulling,
no means yes.
Pulling a page of Sean Connery's James Bond then.
So she should have said yes, because that would have meant no.
I guess yes means no.
Wee-wee.
And apparently, McCarthy said, breathe or I'll kill you, because they were doing a little choking deal.
What the fuck?
Yeah, that's pretty intense. This is
breathe or I'll kill you.
Breathe or I'll kill you. That's what it says right here.
I don't understand. Okay, so she's like choking her out.
She was being choked during the attack. It said, breathe or I'll kill you.
Oh, so she was just being choked with the dildo?
No, just with her hands.
Oh, a little choke, you know.
Oh, okay. Do you like?
But how do you choke someone in like asphyxiation?
Yeah.
Asphyxiation. How do you choke someone and then
maybe
threaten them
strap
to breathe? Like, breathe or I'll kill you.
Maybe it was, well.
Yeah, how do you?
Do it, bitch.
I can't breathe. You're choking me out, dumbass.
Yeah,
fucking hand off my throat and I'll fucking breathe.
I don't get it. I've never understood that, dude. With David Carradine, from NXS, he also died of the same deal.
Oh, Michael
Association.
Did he?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I didn't know that. I knew David Carradine.
I knew David Carradine.
Yeah,
from auto asphyxiation. But, like, I was, all right, I'm gonna delve back a little bit in the middle deal. And I know I'm a little long-winded, so I'll try to keep it short. Too late. But...
you were born short, if you know what I'm saying.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah, I get it. I have a tiny dick, right?
No, that's not what I meant, because I'm Hispanic, I'm short, right?
I was going to tiny dick, but...
Okay, well, your mom has a big mouth. Anyway, no, but when I was in high school, dude, like, back in the day, we discovered this thing, like, oh, hey, man, put your head between your knees, take 10 deep breaths, and then lean back against that wall, and we'll push it up against your throat, and you'll pass out, and it'll be tons of fun. And we used to do that. We used to, like, We used to, make each other pass out.
They did that in my high school, too.
Yeah, it was like something that you would,
It was like a thing of the 90s.
I wasn't going to say that necessarily, but it was one of those things, coming up as a kid, there was pot.
I don't know if they still do that now, though.
There was drugs, there was sex, there was rock and roll, and they're making each other pass out.
Making each other pass out.
No, kids still do it today, but then now they're a lot more savvy. They use, like, ecstasy and Molly while they do that shit.
Yeah, that's true.
But I couldn't imagine doing that while fucking.
I can't.
I want to be awake for the whole thing.
My problem is, we're talking about choking somebody while you're having sex.
Auto asphyxiation.
I don't know.
Right when you're about to.
It's not auto.
Oh, no. If you're jerking it.
Erotic asphyxiation.
It's auto if you're solo.
You're solo.
Vivicarine, old man.
He was hanging himself while he was masturbating.
Tons of money. Well, I used to work. I used to work with a bunch of like off-duty cops, and they would tell me stories of people they would find where they would have like these setups, with like a closet door to where they had a rope going around the closet door and coming out, over the top of the door, and that's where the rope would be, and they would like lean into it, and they would be choking themselves while jerking their gherkin.
Well, they're choking themselves.
Yeah.
The chicken.
Yeah. The pickle. A gherkin is a pickle.
Yes. Whiskey Puss is back.
Hi.
I like how you can just watch her face and you can see that she makes the connection. Like, it's a pickle.
Yeah, that is a pickle. Gherkin, right?
Yes.
And that's why they say it.
Jerking the gherkin.
Yeah. Ew.
But I couldn't.
Listen. Like, I don't know. What are you guys saying? If you're like, actually, I don't know.
If you're
your guys are just talking about solo.
Well, the whole purpose of it is.
I thought you were talking about like somebody actually like choking.
Well, there's that too. Yeah, there's that too.
I don't have that stopping point. Like if I'm
like if
in
you
my
choke
mind,
somebody out, you're
I'm
gonna
try to choke you out. Yeah,
out,
I'm gonna
right.
try to choke you out.
Like
there's no. Yeah, yeah, kind of. Yeah, you're gonna die.
I would freak out, man. I couldn't
like,
do
I
that.
Can't.
Like
yeah,
your eyes roll over all of a sudden.
The choking thing is creepy as fuck.
Yeah.
But if, like, you're, whatever, if, like, somebody wants to, like, squeeze you and hold you that tight, as long as they're not on your neck, that's cool.
Like, I've been in a situation
before.
It's
kind of a choking thing on the neck.
No, not
but
necessarily.
But if they're not on your neck, you know what I'm saying? If their arms are, like, on your shoulders or something.
I've been in a situation before where, like, she liked it up against the wall, standing up, right?
What was his name?
Jerkin.
Hey, speaking of which, we do have to. I say this every time, but we do have to get Ethan on the show sometime. We really do.
I agree. We all say it every time.
Why?
Hey, what's going on?
Ruh-roh.
The Russian is supposed to be silent. Is just coming laughing.
No.
But no, I've been in a situation where, like I, like I said, she liked it up against the wall. I would take her up against the wall. I'm obviously standing behind her, and she liked the hands on her throat, so I would do that. But I wouldn't. I would never choke her out.
Yeah, but did she literally say, "I like your hands choking me"?
I don't know.
No, because she.
I don't think that would happen.
She never said anything about choking me because I would never do that.
But you tried it one time.
No. Listen, no. She did say she liked. She liked it rough, and then she liked to be held in certain ways. And yes, go ahead and grab me by the throat. But she never said anything about choking, so I would never take it to that level. I wouldn't do that anyway.
Would she move your hands up to her neck?
Occasionally. Occasionally, yeah. But that's just because she liked to be manhandled like a caveman. But not choked out like some kind of psychopath.
Manhandled and abusive?
Yeah, exactly. Two totally different things.
Yeah. Hey, Russian.
What's up?
We're discussing if getting choked out.
Yes, he's the best one for this.
Getting choked out is cool during sex.
Oh, mommy loves you.
Yeah, silence.
Is that look she gave you?
Silence is golden.
No, listen. We need
a drink.
An expert opinion.
Fifth opinion.
A fifth opinion.
Personally, I like to be choked out during sex.
Choked out to the point of almost passing out or just choked out in general?
I don't know. There's a certain point where it feels good.
So that's perfect for what we're going to talk about today.
Certain point, like right when you're about to come?
No, like we're about to pass out.
So where you're about to pass out.
All right.
It has to be like a happy medium, like, okay, you're choking me out, and then to the point where it gets you off, and then there's a certain point where you're like, holy fuck, I'm about to literally pass out.
Well, because we were just talking about erotic asphyxiation, and I was always of the belief that when you do the whole choking out business, is like right for dudes. I don't know about for chicks, but for dudes, like you want to get choked out,
a solo deal,
choked out to the point, like right at that point when you're about to come. So I imagine for chicks it's the same deal. Like you feel it coming on, you know, you feel the orgasm coming on, and so that's when you want to get choked out.
Right, and that's right? a misinterpretation, because some people will just do it right off the bat, and it's like you gotta wait.
Yeah. You can't.
Like when you get your DW, you sit there.
No, it's not like that.
No, I know.
That's what you're saying. It's not like that.
Yeah, no, I know.
Doing it, and then you start off by doing it. It's like, whoa, man.
Like, yeah, like we haven't even started fucking. All of a sudden, you're choking.
Like more into it, you know.
Like if it just so happens that that's where your hands are placed, and like you're not choking them, but that's like where your hand is.
How?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like if you're. You're asking how?
Yeah, it's like, I mean. Oh, no, you gotta get on the mic.
You gotta pass him the mic.
I just don't see how the hands end up there unless they're placed there. I mean, I don't know. It's just not my thing.
Yeah, well, your hands.
Next time he's on, we need to get the gaff's opinion.
On the whole choking out thing?
Yeah.
I can tell you right now what he's gonna say. That's a white people thing. Next question.
For you, it might be different because, like, girls have.
Everybody's rolling around here.
Go ahead.
Girls have boobs. So
jokes are jokes.
Tits. Well, guys love tits. So, like, when you're having sex, like, usually the guy's hands are around the neck. Tip area.
Yeah, like, well, if you're in a missionary position, like, you're pushing them together
exactly.
to make, like,
I
one...
I completely understand what he's saying. Like, why would it even get to there? But it does, because we want to either be hugged, love, whatever. Like, we want that in or around that area.
Your face. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
all over my face,
If it's not the boobs, like, nine times out of ten, I'm holding on the shoulders because I'm, like, pushing her closer
so,
to me.
Exactly. So then when that point arrives,
mm-hmm.
if it just slides, like, to the neck, it's not, like, I don't want to be choked out. Other people might, but it's in that vicinity.
Yeah, and like me, I don't want to choke out. I just don't want to be in that position.
Yeah, it's not even, like, choking out. It's like trying to get a fucking grip, you know?
Sometimes what I end up doing, like, sometimes, obviously, a lot of us wear chains, girls wear necklaces and whatnot, but sometimes those girls wear, like, those Tiffany type, they almost look like dog collar type, like, necklaces.
Chokers, they're chokers.
And a lot of times my hands, like, if I see that, I'm grabbing it and I'm yanking her. Not because I'm trying to choke her out, but just because I'm, like, pulling her in closer.
I'm not trying to be on top that long to even worry about that.
Well, yeah, but I mean, if even
you... You have to get
even if you're on bottom, like, you can just yank her in for a quick kiss or something, you know?
No,
am I wrong? You're not all about kissing.
That's why they have hair. See, the thing is,
wait, what?
That's why they have hair. No, they have hair.
I see.
Yeah.
I see what you're saying. Yeah.
All right, so so ready to get in these topics?
Absolutely.
I know which one I'm saving for last.
I want to get all up in those topics.
I know which one I'm saving for last. So the first one, being that we're already talking about it, where do you draw the line in the sack?
Ass to mouth.
Okay.
That's it? That's all you have?
So that's where you go with that?
I'm sharing a microphone.
She just goes ass to mouth and passes it along. Wow. That's it. That means everything else
is good. Everything else is good for her.
Uh-huh. I love him.
Open season. Oh, okay. So she says ass to mouth and she passes it along.
Yeah, I guess there's a wink, wink, nudge, nudge, Iggy, Iggy situation going on.
I don't draw the line at that? Okay.
She's just sharing the mic.
Yeah, that's what she's doing.
You don't draw the line at ass to mouth?
You don't draw the line at ass to mouth?
I've done it. Yeah, I've done it.
Well, I mean, sometimes, like, when you're in the heat of the moment, it doesn't...
You've done it?
I've never done it, no.
You've never...
I've never given a girl ass to mouth, and I definitely have never received ass to mouth. Well, I mean, wait, hold on.
Wait.
No, we were talking about it before, and... I mean, technically, ass to mouth means you have your
penis.
You have your dick. Okay, your penis.
Yeah, I'm gonna say dick.
You have your dick in an ass, and then from there, you take the dick out of her ass and you put it in her mouth.
No,
that's technically. Ass
so
to
now
mouth.
Are you then reciprocating the kiss?
Technically,
is that where you're going with that?
There's lots of variations.
Exactly, so you're reciprocating the kiss.
Exactly my point. So I may have licked the butthole once or twice, and then gone to kiss her afterwards.
Yes.
So but technically, maybe I have given
ding
us to
dong.
Mouth.
Hello.
Ding dong, no pun intended. Hello.
Hello, friend.
But that's just one of those things, like in the heat of the deal, like you don't really think about it, you know?
I can assure you. I mean,
but here's the thing, like if you're definitely thinking about it, if you go to do that and all of a sudden you're like, God, this bitch just ran a marathon, she fucking stinks, and then you're not going to even participate in that kind of
situation.
We're
going to talk about that next. We'll talk about that next. Let's stay away from that. We'll talk about that next.
There's definitely little things here and there that will definitely kind of just like knock you out of the situation and clue you into the reality of the deal. Like, no, maybe I don't want to be doing that right now. Like,
if your nose doesn't want to do it, don't do it.
I'm saying.
We're jumping ahead.
Like, if your nose don't want to do it, your tongue don't want to be there, right?
Yeah.
Nose goes.
That girl probably doesn't want her asshole in her mouth either.
I'm saying.
After that fucking marathon, I don't know. I don't know what girls you're hanging out with, but they should shower.
That was an example. No, I'm not saying that. Of course,
yeah, okay. I got flipped around.
I'm gonna get thrown under the bus. Yeah, like.
I'm sorry, I'm not trying to. I just don't know what you're talking about.
So we were talking about ATMs, and you passed the mic.
ATM, ass to mouth. So tell us a little bit about your situation.
Listen, if you fucking lick a butthole and then do whatever and then kiss a girl, that's one thing. If you stick your dick in a butthole. And
yeah, because licking the butthole is just kind of like grazing the outside.
Completely different thing.
Yeah, but that's on her, not you.
Yeah.
Clearly, it's not on me.
Don't even.
No, not you.
But we discussed this whole Blumpkin thing once before, and you were all like,
he's very, very excited about this topic.
We discussed that whole Blumpkin thing, and you were like, it's disgusting. Yeah, this and that. Oh no! You said you would receive the Blumpkin.
Who
was saying it was.
Who
didn't receive a Blumpkin?
I can't remember. I can't remember how it went. I was okay with it because it wasn't me.
No, I know what it was.
No, I said it was okay.
It was.
I would rather.
Your dick sucked while you're taking a shit.
That's right. That's a Blumpkin.
Girl,
yeah. It's disgusting.
So wait.
No, you said which was worse, getting the Blumpkin or getting the hand job, and I said either one was okay. I think because either way, it's not you.
No, I think I can't was different.
Okay. Hand job?
I think it was
a hand job on the toilet. On the toilet.
Yeah.
All day.
Either way, it's really.
Face in or around that toilet.
It's really not that good for the person giving it to you because you got to still smell that other person's shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've given a Blumpkin before and yeah.
Well, hold on.
I'm not going to lie.
Hold on.
I was young. I needed the money. No. No, but yeah, I've done it, and I was like,
which one? Both of them?
Huh?
Hand job or blow job?
Blow job.
While they're taking a shit.
Yeah, and I didn't even fit. I was like, I can't do this, and I got up.
Yeah, no, yeah. That's not
no,
cool. Nobody
like,
wants to do that.
No, because I mean, your nose is like close to.
Oh God!
No.
Blow my brains out
no.
if that ever
I mean,
came close.
It's
to happening.
One thing to eat an ass out, and it's and it's one thing to get, you know, ass to mouth, but when that ass is actually doing its function.
Ew.
As a human function.
Dumpy.
No.
Dump city.
No,
literally.
Yeah, dump city. Exactly. Yeah, I don't...
Like, eating an asshole out, like, oh my God, I could never. Like, what? How is that different?
How is that different from what?
Than blowing somebody, taking a dump. I
because they're not taking a dump.
I know, but that's still a butthole.
It's still a butthole, but it's not a butthole in use.
Yeah, but you're licking it.
With poop.
But it used to be poop. At some point, no.
There's
hey,
still,
with poop.
But it's also
poop
still particles.
Particles. There's
particles. Sporadic
all day.
Particles
all day.
That's why I'm sorry, but I will not do it. Well, I'm not apologizing because it's good. It's good hygiene. But you don't
What's
do
good
it.
Hygiene?
You make sure that they're showered, washed,
like, do you
clean.
Do it in the shower? Did you give them an enema before?
No.
What's an enema? Peanut doesn't know what an enema is.
I'll enlighten her later.
Okay.
it's water up the asshole,
yeah,
pretty
it's
much.
Pretty
much.
It's like it's an anal
it's a
douche,
cleansing, if you will,
for the most part.
So, I don't want to make you feel like weird or anything. I don't get it. Like eating out an asshole would make me want.
Well,
like even watching somebody doing that.
It's not for everybody. You know,
right.
I think it's almost weirder to watch somebody eat out an asshole than getting it done. I mean, honestly, I mean that's
or
my
doing
opinion.
It yourself, yeah.
Yeah, I could understand that. I'm usually not watching it being. I mean, unless it's important.
You're like, I'm totally involved. I don't give a fuck.
See it from a mirror.
Huh?
I said you're totally involved usually.
Well,
so
yeah,
don't give
I mean,
a fuck.
Yeah.
I get
my
that.
My face is better than ass. Who knows?
Do you do it where your nose touches the balls, or do you do it the other way?
Wow, we're getting
wow.
I want to know. I'm not being a dick.
No, you're not being a dick.
Is your, like a...
Go ahead.
Do you do it to where your nose touches the balls, or where your nose is, like, out in the
air? It depends.
Like, the opposite
You never
way.
Know. Whatever.
Yeah, up
the... Well, if it's a 69 position,
if it's a 69, then obviously it's going to be...
I get
one
it,
way.
But I'm just asking how you
prefer?
How do you prefer it, or how anybody would prefer it?
It's just whatever happens. It's not really like a
like
a
legs
preference.
Spread. Like, do you hold your own legs up, or do they hold them up?
However, it really it's.
God,
it's,
I want to be sexually involved like that. Like, I don't give a fuck, whatever.
Yeah, I mean,
eat
it's
my
like
asshole.
Whatever.
Yeah,
yeah, get it. Get down, you know. Yummy down on it.
Can I? I do want to watch one night. Do you have a boyfriend?
I'm sorry?
I
no.
do. I
you
wanna... want. I just want to know about a lot of things, and that's something that I'm stumped by. Eating an asshole.
Okay. But you watch some gay porn, and then you'll understand.
Gay porn scares me.
Okay,
like,
but you're willing to watch it in person.
Yeah. I feel like he wouldn't be like, like, gay porn and any porn is completely different
yeah,
than
it's,
what
it's fabricated
actual.
And...
So if he's, like, literally eating an asshole, I'm... Whatever.
Well, I mean, I don't have a fork and knife.
Pretty sure they don't on the porn either.
But no, I mean... But yeah, I mean, it's... I mean, I've never... eaten vagina, but...
Uh-huh, what a
but
babe.
I'm sure.
Look at him.
So innocent, right?
Yeah.
Oh, well, then you're so innocent for not being an asshole.
Yeah.
So,
We just cheers our microphones.
As we cheers our microphones,
yeah.
Yes.
No, all right. I used to work with this chick. No. I used to work with this chick. We all didn't, but same place. And one day she was like, oh, she showed me a picture of her fucking asshole, okay?
Oh.
Yes, you know it. Don't say her name.
No names.
You know
who, no names.
I know
who
you're
no talking. Names.
Yeah. She goes, oh, it's not my boyfriend. He's gay. We just worked on my asshole for 5 hours. And it was literally
she
like.
Said her boyfriend was gay?
No, she said it wasn't her boyfriend. It was
oh.
her gay friend.
Oh.
They worked on her asshole for 5 hours.
What does that mean?
Did they bleach it and get it all?
No, they got it big as fuck. Bigger than a quarter, bigger than a dollar coin.
See,
and she took pictures, and it's like legit.
Like gaping.
Like a hole in a black hole that you never want to see ever
yes.
in your life. That's not what you do.
That
like, that's not working on an asshole. That's
no.
just like ramming. I get it. That's like ramming a dick in an asshole.
Well,
right?
It's yeah. I mean, I don't understand why. Number one, I don't know why anybody would want to be stretched out like that.
Yeah, like that's not cute. Why are you taking pictures, girl?
But yeah,
nobody
exactly.
wants to see that.
Exactly.
And
I mean, that is not a glamorous.
I've
shot.
Seen it, and the Russian has seen the pictures too. And a few people that are listening, I'm sure, have seen the pictures.
I just...
So eating out an asshole doesn't involve that?
Well, no. I mean, that's stretching
you don't stretch
out
it
an
out?
Asshole. No, I mean, eating out an asshole is just
like
getting it nice
like, that's
how
an asshole looks like to me.
Ready for entry. It's just like... I, well, I mean, women...
lubricate anyway on their own, but
not their assholes.
No, not their assholes. But vaginas lubricate themselves.
Right.
Assholes don't.
So assholes need to be lubricated.
So, you know, you sort of get it, you know, a little wet, you get it ready, you know, and you got to get it a little stretched out, but no.
Oh. We're going to get you a boyfriend.
Okay. He better not be 50. that's what a lot of people want to set me up with, like, their 40 and 50-year-old friends.
How old are you?
35.
So, like, a 40.
Like a 25?
No. No.
Believe me, I've... Okay, well...
Listen,
I can still pull youngins. Okay.
I like older people anyway. So for you, I don't know, when you want younger, it's just like weird to me.
I like younger
people. But I do have some friends I could introduce you to.
Okay.
I mean, they're engaged, but I'm sure they have other friends.
Hey, Mendel, how old are you?
He's 35.
Old enough to party.
So anyway.
All right, we're not talking about assholes anymore.
No. McSweeney, Mendel.
No, what's next topic? What's the next topic?
No, we're not done with this topic yet.
I need to go do a resume online.
Only one person got to even say anything.
Who?
Mendel's got a whole bunch of topics.
I want this
Mendel loves ass to mouth.
We went to Whiskey Puss first with the, where do you draw the line? You said ATM.
I was the first one.
You said ATM.
I was out of the room for 10 minutes.
Yeah, but we
started the topic while you were here.
We were doing current events while you were gone.
Oh, thank God.
So now we move on to Dave.
Oh, me?
David, yeah. Where do you draw the line?
So, there's been a few things that because we had to talk about this a couple weeks ago. And actually, I think, did you read that list on air?
Not yet.
Oh, okay. There was a few things that I brought up, like scat, number one, anything poop involved, like actual poop. Just because I ate an asshole doesn't mean that I don't...
You don't want a Cleveland steamer.
The feces related.
Yeah.
No Cleveland steamer for you.
You weren't actually taking a shit.
Yeah. Right, I don't want like a what do they call it, a Boston steamer or whatever.
Cleveland steamer.
Barf City.
Yeah.
Like a chili dog or something.
Yeah,
like that.
I don't want the. Yeah, no.
Oh
no.
My
God.
Chili dog. Can you take that?
I don't.
chili dog is where you give a girl a Cleveland steamer and then you titty fuck her afterwards.
Oh well. Yeah.
I thought that was just where you shit on their chest.
Yeah.
I didn't think you had to continue to
Cleveland steamer is where you. The Cleveland steamer is definitely the funky funk. That's where you shit on their chest, and then you follow it up with a pig in a blanket gimmick to go ahead and go through with the chili dog.
Okay.
That's interesting. Okay.
That's the funky funk.
All right.
What else?
Oh,
where else do you draw the line?
Blood.
Obviously, chicks.
Blood chicks. What?
Blood.
Bleeding is different than bleeding.
Any guy will. No, I'm talking about blood. Like, hey, let's cut each other and you know.
I was into that back in the day.
What?
Whiskey Puss does not like that.
I was into that back in the day.
Into what?
Blood play.
You in the blood play?
Blood play, yeah.
You wanted to be blood brother and sister?
No. Well, it was like she could bite me open, but I wouldn't bite her open because I didn't want to cause her any pain, so then she would cut herself.
What the fuck?
She was a little
vampiric type shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not great.
Was her name Elvira?
Different strokes for different folks, right?
But you're not into it now. You're just, like, you just
no,
do whatever
face.
The girl wants you to do.
No, not necessarily.
Okay, so why aren't you still into
it? Like, I won't do anal anymore. Because
but you'll still
I got
cut a bitch open?
No. Like I said, I was a phase. I won't do that anymore.
That sounds terrible. Just the way
no,
you're saying it.
No, not cut the bitch open.
I mean,
like, in a good way.
I may rip a bitch open.
You
know what
I'm saying? I'm sorry.
Yeah.
But no, I won't go that far anymore. That's
very weird. Blood brothers and sisters and girlfriends and boyfriends, I guess. I don't know.
You don't know. But no, like where I would draw the line, I don't do anal anymore because ever since I got pooped on, that wasn't a very pleasant experience.
All right.
Oh, the Brown Derby. Yes.
I had. What else? What else did we talk about?
You know,
that
actually,
discussion.
Just to touch briefly back on the blood thing. I mean, with the gay lifestyle, blood play is not a good idea anyway.
You
never know who's
the is AIDS
and
whatnot.
HIV positive.
That's another reason why I just stopped that altogether, dude. Like, it's not safe.
Yeah.
What about fisting? Fisting's also a spot where I draw the line.
I like his headphones, BT Dubs.
I don't think I would do any fisting. Because there's fist, you know, there's vaginal fisting and there's anal fisting. And
there's no way.
Neither way sounds
like
way.
I would do.
I mean, luckily, I've never been in a situation where a girl's like, take me to Pound Town with your hands. There's no way.
Take me to Pound Town with your hands.
Give me a Jeff Dunham.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't think so.
Give me Mike Tyson. No way.
Super jalapeno.
Strap-ons.
I mean, honestly, I draw the line anything anal related.
Okay, yeah, but well, that's not necessarily fisting. I mean,
no, I know.
But wait, so like,
oh,
obviously,
you mean,
up your anus.
No, well, no.
But what about like, or, if she wanted it in the butt?
Yeah.
If she wanted it, I would do it, but it's
you
not.
You don't
like,
draw the line. There.
Yeah, but I do draw the line. Like that's a negative.
What are you talking about? His asshole.
Really?
Her asshole.
Well, I'm talking about both assholes.
Talking about both. Yeah.
Well.
You know, like.
Like
I
was all about the is anal until I got pooped on, and then now it's almost something like I won't ever bring it up. Like first off, because I'm a big butt guy, so I don't want to ruin the booty, you know.
It still wouldn't ruin it.
I'm like, yeah, but you know what I mean. Like I don't want to defile that temple, you know what I'm saying? But like I'll tell girls, I'm like, that's with me. You don't even have to worry about it. It's not gonna happen unless you request it first, you know. And even then,
and if so, you better
we had to talk about some shit because last time I got pooped on.
Douche it out in the shower.
Yeah. Dude, I have this book in my house. I have this book in my house. You know the John Jameson autobiography, like how to make love like a porn star.
Yeah, Jesus.
And I read it, and there's a portion in there where she talks about what porn stars have to go through for anal stains.
Yeah.
And it's not pretty, dude. Like, they have to not only douche it out, but they can't eat for so long and this and that. Like, it's a big deal, and they get paid tons of money to do it.
Yeah, I was going
to
say, they're making big money, though.
Yeah, I mean, that's a whole thing in the gay... Well, not a whole thing, but I mean, I know a lot of gay guys that, if they know they're going to bottom that night, they're not eating that thing.
Bottom!
I'm sorry, the term bottom?
Yeah.
Never heard that before. What does that mean? I really never heard that before.
Well,
really, we're talking about anal sex. What do you think that means?
Most gay are, you know, if you do anal, because not all gay guys do anal. I mean, there's a lot of old people that are just into oral. But
this guy. Oh, well, I'm not gay. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Except on days that end in Y. But anyway, so. There's, you know,
clarification.
Tops.
Clarification.
There's tops and bottoms. And tops are if...
The givers and the receivers.
Catchers.
I get it. I get it.
The bottoms are the receivers. Yeah, the catchers. So if you know that you're going to be bottoming, you probably don't want to eat for a while, you know, for, you know, a few hours beforehand so you don't have something, you know, building up back there.
Oh, Jesus.
You know,
yeah.
And then you don't give anybody a Brown Derby, like, you know.
can you imagine that?
Goal had gotten.
No pun intended, but can you imagine that shit show?
I don't have to imagine, man. I lived it. It wasn't pleasant. It wasn't pleasant.
I fucked the shit out of that one.
God. Got anything else on this?
Threesome mix and match. What I mean by that, like... A lot of guys are like, yeah, man, I'd love to have a threesome, me and two chicks. But what happens if it's you, a chick, and another dude? I draw the line there. I'm not going to do that.
What was that?
The Russian agrees. Or the Russian's all about two chicks, one dude. Her and I are on the same page.
Well, yeah.
Oh, you agree with that? Mm-hmm. Didn't you tell me
two
you had
chicks and a dude?
Didn't you tell me you had a situation where it was you and another dude and a chick at one point?
I mean,
you were giving the Eiffel Tower?
Well,
the DP.
Are you serious?
I mean, it was a long time ago.
Yeah, but I mean, it happened.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, it happened.
So we can't go back.
Okay, here's what happened. Here's what happened with that. It was a buddy of mine. We went to high school together, whatever. This was...
The Russian obviously does not listen to the show.
Yeah, Russian's very confused. We have spoken about this before.
Shows.
Yeah.
I was very content watching the World Series. Very content. It was, I couldn't even tell you when, 2003, 2004, who knows. And very content.
We get that.
Yeah, okay. So,
but...
So my buddy's messing around with this chick, and the apartment I lived in before, I didn't really like my roommate. He was kind of a dick. And,
So what, they were like being loud near the room?
No, everyone had to hang out in my room. It was pretty much we had to hang out in my room. So he starts messing around with this chick, took her from the living room into my room, and I go, come on, man. I go, you got to go somewhere else. He goes,
didn't he have
trying to watch the
game. I can't. Well, he lived with his mom still.
Oh, I thought you said, oh, it was a buddy. I thought
yeah, no, it was a friend of mine. Oh, no, 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 the roommate. No, the roommate. Oh, no, nobody wanted to hang out with him.
Okay.
So then he got this bright idea to basically be like, well, if you don't do anything with him, I'm not going to continue doing anything with you. And I was like,
because he wanted to stay in the room, so he was trying to sweeten the deal.
Yeah, and I go, okay. Hey, I go, listen, I go, if you want me to leave, that's fine. I go, it's whatever. I'm good. He goes, well, you're just kind of letting her down. He goes, she's going to have to S the D or something to get something done. So had to let it happen. Of course.
Was she a grenade?
No, but I mean, sticky bomb maybe.
Wow.
Maybe not a grenade, but a sticky bomb.
A sticky bomb. Wow.
Yeah, but of course the...
So you participated in the situation?
Yeah, because of course, at that point, oral leads to other...
Okay. So wait, so how did it happen? Did you guys...
Was it like DP?
No.
Oh,
no.
Jesus.
No DP.
Two D's and one A?
No, it was one of those like,
fuck
her.
Yeah, actually, halfway through the deal, I go out to get a little Kool-Aid. Literally Kool-Aid. Literally Kool-Aid.
Because
went out to the kitchen and got something to drink.
Okay.
Hydrated.
Called the gaff.
Okay.
The gaff can talk about this.
I think he has.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Talk to him on the phone. I go, hey. I go, you'll never guess what I'm doing right now. And he goes, what? And I go, hey, hold on. I want you to talk to somebody. So I had to go back in the room. Switcheroo gimmick.
Okay, so he got off and you
were
So
wait, so you were just tag teaming. You weren't really doing a three-way.
Threesome?
Well, for a very small period when it was the...
Unless you had a dick in her mouth and one in her fucking
for a small period of time, yeah, but then it was like a little trade-off gimmick.
So were you seeing this guy's fucking dick?
I did not know because from the position that it was at, I could not see it.
But he saw yours.
It wasn't in my asshole. Now, how did...
The question says because it was in his asshole.
No. I mean, it could have been in hers, but it wasn't.
Because that's where you draw the line, right?
That's a good way to end this.
Oh, man. That's good. Good times. So, want to go to the next topic?
Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah, let's do that.
Because we've spent a lot
of time. And see, we need Whiskey Puss's opinion on this.
All right.
Or,
well, what's...
Or
what's
the Russians.
What's the...
We could use theirs.
We could use
aroma.
Ooh. Sexual
okay,
aroma.
Okay, let me start, because then Whiskey can come back in here and take over, and I can go smoke. So... All right, so, aroma. Yeah, balls have to be washed. Ass needs to be clean.
No stash.
I'm putting myself on blast right now. But last week, I hooked up with somebody. And
what was your name?
I see what you did with that. That's good.
That was good. So, anyway, I had actually worked at the Bucks game that day. And
long day.
It was a long day.
In the sun?
I started working at my day job at 10:30 in the morning. Left there at 2:30, got at the stadium at 4:30, and didn't get out of there.
Oh, that's right, because it was a Monday night game.
Monday night game, yeah.
Yeah.
So I didn't get out till midnight. I got home at like 1. I dropped my buddy off, got home, get the text from this guy,
And he was like, hey, you want to come over? Blah, blah, blah. I'm like, all right, sure. And I'm like,
and blah, 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 he says.
Well, I'm not going to get into the specifics. But, you know, and I was like, sure, why not? And I was like, but fair warning. I said, I've been working all day. I said, I've been out in a
construction. Look at you, like a gentleman. You gave him warning.
Yeah, I said, okay. Look, you know, I'm like, I'm not showered, and I don't feel like it. You know, because the whole thing was I was just going to go over there and help him out, you know.
Okay.
But
you were going to facilitate his needs manually or orally?
Orally.
Okay.
But what year is it manually? Really? Like I mean. Really.
Listen.
His jobs are so 2000 and late.
Yeah, but.
now, the combination between manual and oral.
Well, that's part of
is,
oral.
No, that's a given. It's oral has to involve hands.
If you don't use hands, then you're just an amateur and you should be...
Exactly.
So, anyway, I didn't want to shower. I gave him...
Yeah, Mendel, step your game up.
I gave him the warning. Look, you know, I said, I'm not showered, blah, blah, blah. I didn't think that anything, you know, I wasn't planning on anything with him doing anything to me, you know, whatever.
It's just weird to me, dude. Well, I mean, I realize you're gay, but you're still a dude. You gotta get your rocks off, too, you know?
But he was also straight.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Well, that's nothing
out of the
curveball.
Shit
just got real.
You know what?
Shit just got another day that ends in Y.
But you know what? Like, as the more I speak with Dave, a lot of these situations arise. Like, a lot of straight guys want to see what's up.
That homewrecker website.
Yeah. That's why he's been on that homewrecker website.
But,
for real.
God, I hope people... Okay, yeah, I'm glad.
Don't listen to the show.
You did not hear that. Yeah, but anyway, so... And he actually said to me, he was like, well, to be fair, he's like, I've been moving all day, and I haven't showered either. And he was like...
Oh.
But he's like, if you don't mind, I don't mind. And I was like, all right. I just... Well, because I wanted to see what... Because sometimes, you know... Everybody's crotch is different.
You know what?
Everybody's
agree with you.
pH balance is different.
If I can intervene for just 1 second.
Let him continue.
It's just a quick little thing. There have been times where, like, I'm sitting at home because I have a day off, and then the lady friend comes in, and I just want it right then and there. And she's like, no, you know, I've been at work, and this and that. And it's not going to bother me. Like, we've done this before, you know, it doesn't bother me. I don't care. So I can see where you're coming from.
Yeah, you know, and I was just like, you know, I mean, if it was something foul, then I'd be like, no, sorry, I'm done.
Yeah, if it's really foul, I mean, obviously, let's go ahead and make that clarification now, because that's what the show is all about. If it's really foul, if it smells like something died down there,
yeah,
then obviously you're going to be like, maybe you should take a shower.
Yeah. Or I would have just been like, bye.
Yeah.
But no,
thanks
actually,
for the drinks.
But once I got down there, everything was copacetic. You know, I was like, all right. I'm like, it just smells like...
A dick.
And balls.
Yeah.
So, that's...
Balls do have their own smell, I guess, right?
They do.
I guess.
Yeah.
I wouldn't know because I never smelled it. Well,
you don't either.
Occasionally I get called out on it, too. Like, you need to get a quick scratch, and you're doing a self-check. You've never done a self-check?
I did the check before.
If you say that you've never done a self-check,
I've done a self-check
before,
but I've done a self-check before, but not very often.
Clean.
clean. That's funny.
But anyway.
I've done it before, but...
But it's not like you're grabbing your nuts and pulling them to your face. No, you just kind of like scratch or whatever.
Yeah. I do the wipe.
I mean, it's kind of like... Well, no, it's kind of...
You really got to get it, yeah.
It's kind of like the check on a female. Like the whole...
But you know what?
You go like this?
Do you want to hear a funny story?
Absolutely.
And I was thinking about this on the ride up here, too. There are some times where, like, I'll do that self-check on myself, and I'll be like, oh, that's raunchy.
We're talking about aroma.
But if...
I thought that was a diaper.
Whiskey Puss has to go piss this. All right. Listen.
Easy.
There have been times where, like, I'll do the self-check.
She's doing the check right now.
Whiskey Puss is doing the self-check.
There have been times where I'll do the self-check and be like, oh, that's bad. But then there have been other times where, like, let's say I'm going down on a girl, and that same smell is there.
Yeah.
But it doesn't bother me as much. for some silly ass reason. It's not this.
We're talking about the presentation.
Yeah. But it doesn't bother me as much because obviously, you know, it's not me and it's not as strong or whatever the case may be, but it's just.
Oh, you smell it on her, you mean?
Right.
Oh.
And then later I go back for a self-check and I'm like, that was the same smell that. It's
So maybe your scent tainted her scent.
Maybe my scent is a little more a little more repulsive to me because it's me, you know, and I don't want to go near my own junk.
Why would you go near your own junk?
That's my whole point. You're not because it's a dude's junk.
It's your junk, though. It's not some other guy's junk. It's your junk.
But it's still a dick.
Yeah, but that's on her.
So it's a little a little more repulsive to me than smelling the same smell on her.
So it would be less repulsive if it was some other guy's dick.
No, because it's still a dick.
So at the end of the day, Mendel's 86 dicks.
Dicks, right. That's where I draw the line.
See, maybe because I'm gay. I don't know. Because I'm just like, it's my own. So it doesn't affect me at all because it's...
You may go for a self-check. You may go for a self-check on yourself and be like, oh, it's kind of repulsive. And then like go down on a dude and smell the same smell. But for some reason, it's not as repulsive. That's where I'm getting at. Because it's not you.
Okay.
You feel me?
Yeah. Okay. But I get it.
But he gets it now.
I get it. Why are you looking confused?
Joyce is a little confused.
I think I'm a little more concerned with the other smell other than mine. Now, of course, if I'm properly presented, then I shouldn't have a problem.
Right.
Correct.
But I'm more worried about the other presentation.
What do you mean? It's presented in a very
pleasant
fashion.
Yeah, but you know, one of my fears, one of my worries is the classic the female in the yoga pants.
Ooh la la!
No, it's amazing, but yeah, that's fantastic. You got the classic
peanut gallery is over.
One of the worst words in the vocabulary for me is marinating, because the only thing I can think of when I hear the word marinating.
Is Barf City.
Is a female in yoga pants working out.
When I think marinating, I think steaks. I think chicken.
Yeah,
I think
see.
Pork.
Yeah, I guess I think of beef, but it's not really steak.
Beef curtains?
Yeah. That's bad.
Meat curtains.
No, we're talking about beef curtains. So... Whiskey Puss, what do you think about the aroma
situation?
I think if a guy has the sweaty balls, it's the most disgusting fucking scent I've ever smelled in my life.
Dicks have their own smell.
Peanuts has dicks have their own smell.
That's like the second or third time I've heard that. Like dicks have their own smell. I wouldn't know. I mean, the only
Right, and you're not smelling it.
No. You were off for a cigarette break. We do smell it on dicks, but not like obviously we're not pulling it to our nose. But like,
how do you?
Like you scratch and, all right, well, I'm good to go.
A scratch and sniff, if you will.
Ew.
Before you get crazy.
It's the same. It's the same thing as smelling your armpit. Like you want to make sure that everything's okay. You know.
Yeah, but balls smell funk city.
Not all the time.
Clammy balls are not fun.
Clammy balls are not fun.
See why I think marinating is a terrible word?
Stuck to your butt. your balls are stuck to your butt.
I've never heard my balls stuck to my butt, thank God.
Yes,
stuck to your, like, to your BH?
Like, clammy is fucking just sticking everywhere.
Like,
when you sit down,
your balls kind of stick to your butt a
little. They never stick to my butt, ever. They stick to my leg sometimes.
All right, so
it's because he has tiny balls.
Big balls stick to your butt.
So
I have a buddy of mine. He's 10 years older than I am, and we were talking about like underwear, and he was like,
"Were you doing ATM or MTA?"
What? What was it? What did she say?
That's not bad though.
Mouth to ass.
MTA is not that bad.
Ass to mouth, mouth to ass. No, 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 no.
Ass to mouth.
No, I don't know how we got on the topic, but he was talking about how he was like, you know, yeah, I like to wear those boxer briefs now. And a lot of my buddies who were also in the conversation was like, yeah, chicks like the whole boxer brief thing, you know. I was like, I still wear boxers, just straight up boxers. And my buddy was like, oh, Mendes.
Mendel.
Mendel. I just name dropped. I pulled the whiskey piss.
Aha, uh-huh. Ding dong.
You're going to hate in a couple of years the fact that you wear boxers because gravity works against you and your fucking nizzards are just going to... I'm like, really? He's like, trust me. I speak from experience. They're just going to fucking... He goes, you know what's happening when you sit down one day and you accidentally sit on your balls. I'm like, what?
See, I get that. Yeah, I know. Like, I'm not a guy, but I get that your balls sag. Like, tits sag if you didn't wear a bra forever.
Well, I think in general, gravity is going to take...
But he's
eventually going to sit on your balls.
What he's saying is you don't want to help it along, is what he's saying.
I'd be so mad if I sat on my
balls. Oh, my God. Can you imagine?
Clammy balls. Why are we stuck with clammy balls?
She honestly has had some experience with clammy balls.
I'm just going along with her saying that the balls stick to the butthole.
I know that there are times like...
Literally to your asshole, but to your butt cheeks.
Backwards. No, I've never dealt with that. But there are times where they stick to the legs, like during the summer months, and that's when I powder up. Whoa. I powder up. I'm a firm believer in powder. I powder up.
What's the next...
You don't want to chafe, right?
No, I don't chafe because I'm not a fat fuck, but I do use powder.
Fat fuck?
I think
people chafe if they're not fat.
I chafe.
I don't...
Oh,
I don't,
see, you
I don't,
fucked up. Oh. You fucked up.
I don't mean to offend anybody, but I don't chafe. I don't even know what that is.
It's uncomfortable. That's what it is.
I heard it's riding the red rocket. Like, you...
riding the red rocket.
No, but coming from the same guy that has two hernias, a dislocated back, this, that, you've never chafed in your life.
No. A what? A prolapse anus.
Chafing is uncomfortable, let me tell you.
That's
like,
a pink sock, isn't it?
A prolapse anus? Oh, is that what it pulls out?
That's what it looks like. That's scary. Okay.
Tell me you didn't go down on that one.
No. That's good.
Could you hear that?
Yeah. No.
Holy shnikes.
No.
Sketchy. That'd be very sketchy.
That's like a sausage casing without the fucking meat on the inside.
Like, yeah, the casing of bologna.
I'm sad I even brought that up now.
All right, so are we going to the last little main event topic?
Yeah, what was that one? I don't even remember.
So
cheating.
Did we just finish aroma? Is that
was? Yeah, we finished up aroma.
Okay.
Cheating is
now,
the next topic.
Now, what we're talking about here cheating is if, let's say, you're in a relationship, and you could cheat, and it would save your relationship, and the other person would never find out, would you do it?
Of course.
That's the main question, but just cheating in general.
If it's going to save the relationship, why wouldn't you do it?
Yeah, but still.
But coming from the other person in the relationship, it wouldn't save it. If you're in, like, marriage is how I picture this topic.
Married, kids, whatever, yeah.
Yeah. Would you cheat if you could?
That wasn't the question. The question was if it would save the relationship.
Okay, coming from both sides? Or just your side?
Well, the other it can only come from one side. I'm only one person. All
right, if you went to your wife and you're like, listen, if I cheated, would it save our relationship?
I would.
Yeah, but the whole thing was them not finding out. Now,
yeah,
but in the same sense, what would you feel like if you were on that other side of that?
Oh, I see what you mean. Like, if she had to cheat to save the relationship. But if I didn't know any better... If I didn't know about it, then it didn't happen.
No,
yeah, but something would change.
Both of you guys said, hey, yeah, I have this side bitch, and I'm going to do it. Then if you guys are both
bitch.
Okay with it.
That's just swingers. That's not cheaters.
Yeah.
Yeah, if both parties were agreeable, that's swinging.
All right, but they're not both fucking them.
Oh, swingers are when you get, like, couples fuck each
exactly.
other.
Exactly. They're both getting it.
Yeah.
Getting after it.
Not necessarily.
But let's say.
But.
Get back to cheating.
If you're.
Hold on.
Honestly, like. If you're cheating, it's for a reason because you're not happy.
Exactly.
And you're not going to tell your significant other.
That's not necessarily true either.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so you're going to be like, hi, I'm not happy with you. I'm going to go fuck some other guy.
But we're going to be straight afterwards.
But afterwards, I'm going to feel much better about myself,
yeah,
right?
Absolutely.
And I still want you to go down on me and lick my asshole.
Right, yeah. It's like, that's like saying, like, hey, let's take a break.
Exactly.
Let's just take a break.
Okay.
There's no such thing as a break.
Right. It's a...
Separated.
Yeah. It's like, we're going to take a break. I'm going to go find new stuff. And
it's... A new D on the side.
Right. And then see if I like him more than I like you.
Jones.
Pretty much.
There's a reason why...
New stuff Willie equals relationship Jones.
Yeah.
If everybody was happily married and happily in a relationship, there would be no need to cheat.
That's wrong.
That's wrong.
I watched.
Please enlighten me.
I watched this documentary on, it was called The Science of Sex Appeal, and they speak about how it's unnatural for people to be completely monogamous for their entire life.
And I get that, but.
So cheating will happen.
I completely get that, but that's what your 20s are for. To do whatever the fuck you want. And
but you're not 20 forever. It talks about your entire life.
Okay.
Being monogamous to one person.
I get that, but you can go to work and you can flirt with people and you can do whatever, but it doesn't mean taking your clothes off and having sex with a different person.
That's true, but flirting only goes so far, and after that, after it reaches a certain point,
right.
you have
and
to proceed forward or cut it off.
That's why
it goes as far as you want it to go. That's what
why
it is.
Yeah. Everybody gets divorced now because they think they find the best one, and then they get divorced and divorced and divorced.
Not now. That's been going on forever, dude. That's
all right,
old.
But it's a lot more now than it used to be.
Divorce.
That's what I'm saying. Everybody
like
says that, but it's always just been.
Percent.
It's always just been.
Right. I want to hear your point.
You want to hear what?
My point. Yeah.
My point is that it's according to this documentary, it's unnatural for people to be in a monogamous relationship for their entire life.
Your entire life, yeah.
This day and age.
But that's what marriage is supposed to be. It's supposed to be forever.
It's not your entire life.
Yeah, that's just your married life.
What the fuck is that supposed to mean? No.
Well,
death to this part. That's what marriage is. That's what marriage is.
Let's say the first person you're with.
Okay, yeah.
Let's say the first person you're with is 18.
Well, I'm sitting pushing 40. Fuck you guys for saying anything. And I'm still not married because I eventually want to do it right. You know? No offense.
Well, no, I get it.
No, it's like back in the day, all of my parents, I don't know, my parents are still married. They didn't get married till they were 25. The parents before them married at 16. Like, every day it changes. Every different fucking generation changes.
Right.
And yeah, you don't want to be monogamous for your entire life. You're not going to, the first person you have sex with is not going to be the person you're going to end up with.
No, most definitely. Well, it shouldn't be. Some people, it is that way.
Right. And it was, what, I don't know, many, many years ago. But
yeah.
That's why, like, you should wait and wait and find the person that you truly want to marry. And then you can be monogamous with them. All right, half the crew.
Half the crew just peaced out of here.
I think somebody's checking on the intern to make sure that they're not up and pissed off.
The intern or the Russian?
No, for door slamming.
I don't know.
No, it was the Russian.
But regardless, though, the whole cheating situation, though, like, go ahead. I'm sorry, you were going to say something?
I was just going to, I mean, because I've, you know, I've, and I'll be the first to admit this, that I've not been in a actual official relationship.
Ever. Oh.
But I've been.
Which, by the way, sucks because you're a really good guy.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I
know, but you know, it is what it is. So anyway, but I've been the other person that people have cheated on
with
spouses with.
Right.
Homewrecker.
That's
what
I'm going to be on the website. yeah, but.
Which.
It's just, I mean, from my standpoint. Being that other person, I mean, it's not like they're cheating on their spouse because they're not happy. The ones that I've been with, they've cheated on their spouse because they're curious about something that they've thought about almost
You're talking about straight.
Their whole life.
You're talking about straight guys.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And they choose you as the outlet.
You know, and you know, and they're See, like, you I know, don't. I'm sort of curious about this. You know, and me being me, I'll be like, oh, yeah. I'm like, well, why don't you?
Let me show you how
let me,
to go.
Yeah, if you want to explore, you know.
See, that's
complete. Nobody I know ever hears this show. But I really don't. But, you know, I mean, and I will, you know, I'll volunteer. I mean, because if it's just like, oh, you know, you want to get a blowjob from a guy, okay, fine, you know.
I'll be that guy.
Yeah, I'll be that guy. That's fine.
Right.
You know? And I mean,
I completely get
and,
that.
And they've come back for seconds, thirds, and fourths, but, you know, because amazing and impressive. Because
he's good.
But,
he's good.
You know, we're still talking about cheating.
Oh, okay.
Second,
thirds,
and
fourths.
Yeah, yeah.
Guys go back to him after they've been a little curious.
Yeah, but for, like, I honestly feel like it's a lot harder for.
That's not what we're talking about.
Gays to do that, you know, like a curious guy. They're never gonna call themselves bisexual or anything. They're just curious.
One has pretty much admitted, yeah, he's
okay.
Like, I'm bi.
But for straight girls, straight guys, whatever. It's like if you're cheating, you're cheating. It's completely different. Like I understand
oh,
the
it's
whole
still,
like
I
oh
mean,
trying
I'm
to
not
figure
trying.
Out what you want.
I'm not trying to
I
say
know.
It's not cheating.
No,
I mean,
that would be cheating. No, I mean these guys are in they're in straight relationships and they're curious, so they go to Dave. That's
which,
cheating.
It's cheating.
That's cheating,
it's
but
cheating.
I understand why you guys are like, oh, like whatever, it's fine. But if somebody's actually cheating, I keep hitting that thing. So you like once a cheater, always a cheater. If you're married,
not necessarily.
You don't think so?
I don't think so. I really don't
think
so.
I feel like if you're
young,
in a serious relationship, you don't cheat. If you are so happy in a serious relationship, you don't cheat.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you say once a cheater, always a cheater, but there could be somebody, you know, coming up and they're young and they're having several relationships, but they're not ever completely happy or satisfied in those
or
relationships.
Or in an actual
so they cheat.
Relationship.
So they cheat, and then they come across that one person, and boom, that's the person. And then they decide not to cheat anymore because they're satisfied.
Right.
So you can't really say once a cheater, always a cheater.
Yeah, no,
you know?
That makes sense, absolutely. But
the way karma works, that one guy who's cheated all his life and has found that one person, he doesn't want to cheat anymore, and then she's going to cheat on him. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah, karma's a bitch.
It's a dirty game.
Oh, it is.
You got to play dirty to win it.
Hey.
I'm still kind of hung up on the. I personally don't think there's such a thing as a bisexual male.
I do.
Why? Oh, wait, because you're straight. Okay, that's right. And you believe in labels.
And
okay,
I'm a girl,
ahead.
And I totally
well, no,
believe
the only,
that.
The only reason
you
I think that.
Listen, girls all day, oh, everybody thinks it's so hot when girls want to fucking go with another girl. No, it's every sexuality has that.
I think you either suck dick or you don't, period.
No.
So then you're on the same plane as me?
So, okay, so my question to both of you is, so if a guy gets curious one time,
can they
sucks a dick, all of a sudden they're gay for the rest of their life because they sucked one dick?
No.
No,
but
not necessarily.
He may want to go back
listen,
to sucking dick.
I feel like every guy that has ever done that says they're drunk as fuck. Does that make sense or no? Or is that stupid?
Like it was like a drunk thing.
Like, oh my god, I was so drunk.
I can see that happening because they're trying to save face in the straight community.
That's I mean, yes, possibly that one time maybe they were drunk.
Right.
But even if they weren't, it's because they're trying to save face. Like,
yeah, they're trying to
I
save
did
face.
It. I enjoyed it. I don't want to go back to it anymore.
Right.
But I can't openly admit that that's what I enjoyed because all my, you know, like I meet some girl later on down the road and it's going to come out and it's going to fucking
right.
complicate things or whatever.
I personally don't think that, I mean, because it seems there's a lot of straight guys that are like, oh, well, there's no such thing as a bi man. Well, yeah, there is.
I agree. You know what? I take back what I said.
Oh, now you take it back.
Now
he takes
it
back.
All right. Let me get a mic.
anybody can be bisexual, but it's more accepted for a woman to be bisexual.
Absolutely.
I don't understand. You know what, though?
It's because guys.
A straight man's fantasy is two women together.
Absolutely.
God forbid two men should be together. That's the devil.
I never said that. It's just
not
for me.
No, I'm not saying you, but, you know, I mean, that's how most straight men feel.
Do you guys think... I feel like what they're going to say is not going to be what I wanted to say, but do you think you could ever get drunk enough to, like, make out with a guy? S the guy's D.
S the guy's D?
No, wait. You just went from...
You said making out with a guy, and then you said S the guy's D.
Yeah, you went from...
Same thing. Like,
no.
Honestly...
That's not the same
it's
thing.
Not, clearly, it's not the same thing, but... I know for a fact if I asked you guys if you would ever make out with a guy, it would be
Now, I think that if I got super drunk enough and it came down to whatever situation I was in, it was like a day.
Tons of girlfriends.
Whether it was like a day or whatever the situation is, I could 1,000 times over see myself making out with a dude than I could ever S in a D. Like, there's a line.
There's a humongous line.
Like,
and is that the line?
Huh?
What about getting your DF?
No. Still no.
I agree with him about the whole making out situation and the whole S and a D. Getting your DS'd, I'm going to put myself out there and say that I...
You would let him?
I would let him, but it would be one of those situations where it's like... I would say, all right, here's what I'm going to say. I would say that right now it would never happen, but I'm not going to put it beyond the limits of a possibility. That I could see happening.
You never know.
You never know.
I get that.
Right? Just because, but you're, Joyce, you're totally no.
I would say no.
See, what's crazy is I've made out with tons of girlfriends and like, whatever. Like, I don't understand why it's so normal for girls to fucking...
Because girls are hot. Girls are seen as prizes and guys are seen as...
Yeah, but...
Guys are seen as the seekers of the prize. That's in my eyes.
If I make out with a chick, it's... Not because I'm trying to seek a prize, it's just because we're hammered drunk.
I think it's estrogen.
I think it's testosterone. I think you guys should make out right now. Let's get to a new subject, please.
I'm not making out.
Hey, can you guys both do the fireball challenge 3 times over? That'd be a really good show.
No, it wouldn't.
Yeah, it would.
No, it'd be terrible.
I agree with her. Well, at least that you should do it twice because you've already obviously proven that you can do it once so easily.
Very easy.
Yeah, you took that like a champ.
Wait, I think we all need a fireball shot.
Pun intended. Get the Russian opinion in here to get us some.
No. Yeah, those little bitches.
They're having a counseling session outside.
What the hell happened? Bitches.
Did
somebody show up?
Bitches be so sensitive.
Wake up?
No.
Oh, okay. Fuck them.
Fuck them. See, she knows the motto. Why don't you know the motto?
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Don't make me rap, please. I almost did.
Okay, so
all right, what's the next topic?
We're ready for the McSweeney minute.
Oh, shit.
I need my girl in here for that.
Oh, you need your girl in here for that.
Peanut.
You need peanut in here
Kelly.
For that.
Are you not ready?
No, I have tons of time with you guys.
And I'm ready, dude. I just, we got to get Peanut, because apparently Peanut is involved
no,
with
you
him soon.
No, you
go
do go yours. You do, let
no,
me go.
Go.
No, you just...
There's nothing to say that you're
going to
do it quick enough.
I will. What? You guys are going to talk for fucking 10 minutes.
What are we going to talk about?
I feel like, give me the headphones. I feel like the more people that are involved, the funner the show is, but it's chaotic. It's chaotic. Like, everyone's in and out.
Well,
why
don't you guys talk about...
I think
wait, hold on. Whiskey Puss is giving us ideas right now.
This may or may not be disgusting, but you guys should talk about... Nah, got
it. No, say it. Go ahead, say it.
I'm looking at children's things. Pedophiles.
About what?
I don't want to talk about
people
pedophiles.
People fucking children. No, everybody... I hope everybody disagrees
on
that.
That shouldn't be on a sextacular show, because that's not sextacular.
That's a given. That's a given. That's where we draw the line.
Did you guys talk about the
we don't talk about
incest?
Pedophilia. We don't talk
about... Did you talk about incest yet?
We didn't talk about incest.
Really
Ophelia.
I would do two brothers. I'm just saying.
Ophelia.
Ophelia.
Would you fuck your cat?
What the
fuck? Interspecies erotica?
Yeah.
Is this because of the whole website you guys just told me?
Personals.
Personals.
It's all personals.
I wouldn't fuck a cat.
Would you put peanut butter on your balls?
Would I put peanut butter on my balls? No, I would.
Would you put peanut butter on your balls?
I know something we could talk about until Whiskey Puss comes back.
If you were drunk enough, would you put peanut butter on your balls?
No.
I think you would.
I think I would use a vacuum cleaner before I use a cat.
No, why?
What do you mean, why?
That's weird.
What's a vacuum cleaner?
Your reaction leads me to believe that when you're drunk, you probably put peanut butter on your junk.
Oh, all day.
Gator all day.
Barf City.
My cat, my animals hate peanut butter now.
Because they ate it so much.
Too much.
Yeah, so no.
Keep going.
I got something until she comes back with peanuts so we can do the McSweeney Minute and end this shit.
Are you waiting till I leave?
Well, not waiting till you leave, but waiting till you come back.
You hear
so
him?
We can do the McSweeney Minute.
And we can end this shit. Like, this show is, like, beneath him. Like,
well, no. I'm just, you know, just trying to get it.
It's chaotic, right? Like, we have a lot of people here, and it's very fun for us.
Yeah.
I'm wondering, as a listener, if it's like, who's going to be on? Who's leaving for a cigarette? Or
no, it's not too bad, because it's like segments that are coming in and
I've
out.
I've only left once.
Hey, listen, I got a segment for a show. I really do. And I know this is going to come...
tonight's show?
No. A future show, which is going to be amazing. A trivia show, which could lead to the electric tennis racket.
I would love a trivia show.
We have to discuss that. I mean, if it's just us, a bunch of dudes doing trivia, and we're going to shock each other, like, is it going to be a...
On the balls will be good on that aspect, yes.
Jesus.
But this is good. No, this is great.
I need one.
Are you smarter than a Hooters girl? We could find a random Hooters girl from wherever they are, wherever... Are you smarter than Hooters girl? Classic Trivial Pursuit.
I would fail. I would fail.
You would fail?
Okay.
Classic Trivial Pursuit?
No, not classic, but I mean just Trivial Pursuit.
The only Trivial Pursuit I was ever good at was the Star Wars edition.
That, well...
Yeah, but, I mean...
Unfair advantage right there.
I mean, in a way... No, basic knowledge. Trivial Pursuit in some... Like, based on the... Like, the...
We should do... You know what we should do? We should do Sporkles. I love that fucking shit.
Yeah, but we can't copy Sporkle.
Copy Sporkle? All they do on the goddamn Cowhead show is they look it up on the website.
Yeah, but they do it on the Cowhead show. We can't do it.
Well, we can do something.
It's not copyrighted, man. They just went off the website. What are you talking about?
Yeah, but wouldn't it be funnier if you had a couple people, like two or three people, just had someone naming something off? One of them being...
All right, we will choose a random Hooters girl, and we would do, okay.
Are you smarter than Hooters girl? Like, trivia, basically.
I've already got a few Hooters girls who are smart in mind.
We're going for the smart ones?
Well, not necessarily.
No.
They're not all smart.
No, because they're going to play against us.
Yeah, I know. And Dave's like, no. Oh, I'm sorry. Well, I forgot. We're not named off of that. We want to win, but we want to be challenging.
Challenging. Not idiotic, but
because what happens? Like,
we need more microphones. Number one.
Oh, there's room for one more.
We're gonna get hit in the nuts with a fucking electric racket. What do they get?
They got hit.
It's got to be something even. So I guess it can't be the nuts.
So
if we play, then it could be in the nuts. But if it's male, female,
we
obviously
give
can't do the nuts.
A tit punch.
No, I can't punch. Can't punch.
Oh my god, that would be amazing.
Yeah, that nuts for a nipple.
Nuts for a nipple. We'd have to just find somebody to meet that criteria, though. There's no way that's gonna happen.
There's a couple who said that they were willing to.
They're
gonna
be like, "You just want to see my tits." I'm like, yeah, but that's not really what this is all about.
We really want to zap the fuck out of them. That's what we want.
Oh, my God. No way. We can't zap the nipple, dude.
Why?
You know what?
No, because they'd have to be all perked up
this
and everything.
This is a good idea. It's a good concept. We just have to develop a little actually work it in.
But, like, some type of trivia. Like, we could do a trivia. I think a whole Sporkle concept would be good.
I think listeners should submit questions.
Boom. All two of them.
I think the show needs.
Yeah, to all two listeners on the Facebook page.
It'll be a quick contest.
Yeah, all two on the Facebook page. So the Facebook page is Consummate Opinion.
That follow on SoundCloud. They can comment on SoundCloud.
You can. That's true. Same name that you find us on SoundCloud. You can find on Twitter. You can find on
they can
Facebook.
Tweet their questions.
Tweet questions.
We need to bring this shit worldwide.
Prestige. Worldwide. I want to give a quick shout out. Can I do that? To KB and Captain Blue Shirt.
Captain Blue Shirt.
Who's a recent follower, actually.
I am looking forward to maybe sometime along the way, bringing them on the show.
Oh. Are you smarter than a Hooter Girl?
You know what? I think it would be comedy gold to bring them both on, because those two are at each other's throats all the time.
They can actually do the first.
They could have their
like
own
a first
podcast.
Trivia. They could do it.
We can bring KB on. She could be the Hooters girl that I always go up against.
Yeah.
Oh.
Because I know she could take a punch. Not because I hit her, but she just looks like she could take a punch.
She's probably pretty smart though.
Yeah.
She.
No. Yeah, I disagree with you.
I don't know. Okay.
Boom, bitch.
That was not me. That was not me.
I did not say that. I don't know.
I guess we're down to one person who could have said that.
Yeah, but anyway, like I said, Captain Lucia would be on our team, dude.
Hey, so let you know ahead of time, we're trying to put another show together this week.
This week, and supposedly the Gaff.
Yeah, the Gaff wants to be back Friday night. To throw something together. I don't know what it's going to be about, but we're going to come up with some stuff.
Whether I'm president or not, that motherfucker better have his freestyle ready.
I'll let him know. I'll let him know tomorrow.
Tell him that's his admission fee.
Now he's going to have to give me O for that. He's been gone for a while.
What do you mean, give you O? What does that mean?
Is that like a mouth hug?
Yeah, mouth hug. No homo.
You're going to get him to smell like a donut?
Yeah.
Chocolate glaze?
Glazed donut.
You're going to glaze his donut?
Yeah.
You know, it's funny. With all the bisexual and gay talk tonight, there's not... That's the first no homo. And nobody said HST.
There was one time I was going to say no homo. It was something I said, but he had the mic at that point. I didn't have a mic by me, so... Yeah.
It's implied, when we're talking about Joyce, that it's all about the HST. Because he's the swizzling specialist. That's why he took that...
Obviously.
Four shots so quickly down the gullet, dude.
I don't know how I did that.
I have to say, you swallowed it so fast, you made my pants tight.
I think little Kim would be proud.
And Alanis Morissette, if you believe it.
See, I don't know anything about Alanis, but...
Supposedly, you said what? Alanis Morissette had so much semen in her stomach, she had to have it pumped out?
Supposedly, her and little Kim both.
And little Kim?
Yeah.
I don't know if I believe
that. Was it Ryan Reynolds?
Yeah, was it? Cause,
what?
You know, they were engaged. I said, was it Ryan Reynolds?
This was a while ago I heard this.
Oh.
Who was
like
engaged?
A while ago.
Ryan Reynolds and Alanis Morissette were
Jesus
engaged.
Lord, I didn't know anything about that.
Yeah, they're both Canucks, and they were all Canuckin.
Eh?
Isn't he a lot younger than her?
Yeah.
Cougaring it out.
That doesn't mean anything.
Oh, yeah,
out.
I mean...
Vicky Guerrero, Cougar.
Yeah. It's a little bit ironic, don't you think?
A little too,
I do think.
So you got do you have a McSweeney minute?
I thought you had one all set up.
No, I don't have a McSweeney minute.
Individual McSweeney minute.
We're doing individual McSweeney minute?
No, yeah. We've been doing that lately. Yeah, I forgot you're not always on the show. Yeah.
Oh, I did not know that.
Yeah, do you got anything you want to talk about for about 60 seconds?
Oh.
I got one if you want to ponder.
Yeah, I do want to ponder.
Okay.
All right. I'll go.
All right, well, give me 1 second.
No, don't even bother measuring the shit because measuring it.
Ooh. Yeah,
because it's gonna destroy you anyway. That's why don't measure it. No,
wow.
I'm saying don't tell me that because I always end up going over anyway.
It's the only time you can ever say that. Oh, you got headphones on? Oh, brutal.
Here, Dick.
He has to stand up like he's at a pulpit or something.
Yeah, my McSweeney minute. I did a little rant on the Facebook yesterday about this. My McSweeney minute is on motherfuckers who won't leave me alone have what's called a bitch face or a serious face. Okay? People approach me all the time. I'm such a foul mood. You know, what's wrong? Nothing's wrong. I'm not in a foul mood. People continue to tell me that I'm in a bad mood when I'm not. And really what ends up getting me in a bad mood is these people persisting on the fact that I'm in a bad mood. Really? Go eat a bowl of dicks and leave me alone.
You're in a bad mood.
You see?
People already saying it.
People already saying it.
Not now, clearly, you're standing. You're in.
Hey, shut the fuck up.
Thanks,
continue.
Buddy. Thanks, buddy. But no, but yeah, I just did it again. That's your MO.
Yeah, no?
Yeah, no.
Are you done?
Yeah, I was on the roll. I got interrupted, and yeah, I'm done, dude. Like, it just aggravates me. You know what? I'm not alone. I know there are tons of people. I think maybe even Whiskey Puss suffers from the same thing, where we're completely okay, but for some reason, people think that we're pissed off.
These won't fit.
And they'll just, why don't you smile more? Hey, what's wrong, sweetheart? You know what? I can remember the very first time it happened to me. I was in fucking kindergarten. I was waiting in line to go into the lunchroom. This little, I call her little, but she was probably taller than me because I'm fucking Hispanic, but she was in front of me, black girl, looks over at me and goes, why are you mad? And I had no fucking clue what she was talking about. It's not that. I wasn't angry. I was just sitting there. But the more people that approach you about something like that, the more aggravated you get. It's just fucking annoying and it's irritating. And then eventually you do get in a foul mood and they go, see? Told you so. Fuckers.
So is that a double McSweeney minute?
A double?
Double. You started, stopped.
I'm a double head on Chandra and a mountain Chandra.
Look at how she grabs the juice.
Yeah. Yeah, double.
Double.
Yeah, microphone and headphones.
Yeah, double mic. Hey, she's going to have
she's
to use your
for
headphones.
DP situation. Here, let me get that mic.
Sounds like joints.
Oh! Yeah, oh, you hey, called your ass out.
Let's switch.
So really hot. God. Thank God. This one's not as hot, but Jesus. Why is the microphone
so you got that McSweeney minute?
I no. Whiskey, do you have a McSweeney that you want to do?
Yeah, she does. No,
I have a
she's
few.
Ready.
I have a few.
You have a few.
Oh.
You have a few, okay. No, go ahead.
It sounds so stupid. It does, and so do I. Cause I'm not hammered, but I sound stupid over the microphone. So, when you work at a restaurant, your managers are like, hey, yeah, let's book a party. Hell yeah, we'll give them free tea. Free sweet tea, free iced tea, whatever you want, or water, or coffee. And then when they order a huge buffet, oh, yeah, your other manager said we could bring in chips and dip.
Bullshit.
All day. Bullshit?
No. I'm not saying that what you're saying is bullshit. I think it's bullshit that happened.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I think Joyce was the one that approved that. So they set up chips and dip for every table. Oh, no, don't worry. They're going to... Well, clearly, they're all going to order more shit because you ordered 50 wings and a Hooters salad.
And I agree with you, too. Like, if you have so many people that are going to show up,
70.
Why
70 was
why
the
offer
number.
Free drinks? That's more money in your pocket if you
exactly.
don't offer free drinks.
Oh,
that's
free
stupid.
Tea? So every person that sat down, sweet or unsweet tea is what they told them.
And then the girls
and then they all
have
chips and dip because the other manager's like, yeah, you can bring in chips and dip.
They have to do more work.
They brought in 30 bags of chips and 10 pounds of dip. Joyce. They did. You know who wanted to blow their brains out? The other two managers that didn't approve it and the three girls working the party who got, oh, we got free chips and dip over here and free tea and tea over here.
Just turned into a lynching.
Yeah. It pisses me off. So then by the time they're done, they're like, okay, well, they're... okay, so they have to pay for their sodas, and then they have to, but whatever else they want. And they're like, can I get a Coca-Cola? And the person slaps him and goes, no, you're either getting sweet or unsweet tea.
And then you guys have to make more tea.
Or six.
Exactly, and then I'm brewing fucking sweet tea all day long. My arm's getting fucking numb because all I'm doing is brewing iced tea because they say it's not sweet enough because they need sweeter iced tea and then it's too sweet and I can't.
Obviously pouring tons of sugar in there to give these
yeah,
diabetes.
Pissing them off. Oh, it's not sweet enough for you? Here you go. I poured two bags in there and now it's too sweet. Oh, but they got their chips and dip from the other fucking faggot manager that said that they could bring fucking chips and dip in. And they're like, put the
buffalo shrimp at the end of the table so nobody eats it. Oh, well, yes, please. That's the most expensive thing on the menu.
Yes. Well, that went well. Man.
$49 later.
Yeah, nobody made shit. Anywho, it's what's yours? What's your big Sini? I can think of a couple more.
I mean, if you want to keep going, you can. I mean,
I'm good.
You're good? You're good?
Yeah.
No, go ahead.
I really don't know how I can follow that one.
Yeah, you probably should have gone last with that. That's
good. I think I just did.
I just have to say your computer's so gay.
It is. It is. You're right. I got a pretty good deal on it from a friend of mine who's a DJ. It's covered in flowers. I get it.
DJ.
Yeah.
DJ Flower Pants. Okay.
You got a good deal on it. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. I got a good deal on it.
It's pretty.
Yeah, I guess.
I don't know what to McSweeney about today.
What pissed you off today?
McSweeney.
Just the name in general pisses you off. What's going to piss you off tomorrow, Joyce? Deal with all those huge list.
Yeah, it's not supposed to be more than 25, but I have a feeling it's more than that.
It looked like 30, 35.
That's fine.
Oh, you're going
to... I should be in a...
Hey, what is it? Chocolate danger.
It's what, 3:15? I get up in about 4 hours, so awesome. It should be good.
Should
have a really good class. Yeah,
absolutely.
Because being that Mendel forgot some of the pertinent information that I needed, I have to go to the store and get some stuff printed out. I'm pretty excited about that. So.
Huh,
He's a fucking winner.
Should we show up? Should we show up just to have fun?
Oh yeah, and I'm gonna be babysitting.
Fantastic. Oh, yeah.
There's going to be a 1-year-old there. Fantastic.
Yeah.
We love you.
He loves
babies. Okay. Yeah, I got a McSweeney, I guess.
Is it about looking ass?
Hopefully. No. I want to hear more
about
that.
It's not about S&D either.
I want to honestly hear about how that all goes down. Like, I don't know how you get into the...
Time.
I don't know, understand how you get into the moment of, like, hell yeah, I want to lick your ass.
Well, then we're just going to have to switch numbers, and we'll
talk.
Hell yeah.
Oh.
And I'll
blow your mind.
Explain it all to you.
How do you get in the moment to hell yeah, I want to lick your ass?
That's pretty much how... Because it was a whole topic. It was a whole topic earlier. So she's
changing numbers about looking ass.
What about looking ass though? Because supposedly that's my specialty.
Oh. Why don't you tell me about it?
Oh.
Wow.
There's nothing to tell. There's nothing to tell.
Turned into perfect, Doc.
Perfect. Yeah, perfect.
Ask
what is
cats
it?
About
meow.
Oh, they're pretty good at it, too.
Personals.
Meow.
See, you just got them all hard now.
Yeah, my pants are tight a little bit.
He went from 6 to midnight.
Yeah.
Like, who's my little girl?
He thinks somebody's looking his asshole. So it's very strange.
No, I think somewhere along the lines I had said something about, like, you know, oh, what, you don't look that asshole before? No, I would never do that. When you get a little older, you just kind of just eat all of it and don't really pay attention. And then that got misconstrued. Oh, hey, licking assholes is his specialty. Really? Really?
Who said that?
I don't know. I don't remember who said it. It kind of leaked down. It trickled down the fucking asshole crevasse, I guess.
Crevasse.
Oh. Like a grapevine.
Oh, wait, I'm sorry. I meant to say the grapevine.
But you said cream pie? No, sketchy.
He said cream pie. I'm not all about the...
Mendel. Mendel's licked a butthole once
Mendel's
or twice.
Post cream pie.
Post cream pie.
Is it off the whole time?
No, it's on.
No, trust me. We can hear you.
All right, so am I McSweeney-ing? Is it my turn? Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry
to interrupt.
No, you did.
No, you did.
So I don't do the service industry, but I have an office job, and there's lots of assholes in that too.
No pun intended.
My McSweeney, I guess, is about people that you give work to, that work in other departments that are supposed to get stuff done for you, so that you can get your job done. This morning, I passed off some work to somebody in my engineering department. It was like 10 minutes after I got to work, I sent it to him. And I would say at 3:30, I'm like, did you get this done for me? Because I have an order for this, and I need to get this done. And he's like, oh, no, you didn't let me know that it was a rush.
You passed it off in the morning.
In the morning. It was 10:45 when I sent the email to him.
And this motherfucker's asking.
And I asked him at 3:30, did you get it done?
Right. And he's like, oh, you didn't tell me it needed to be rushed off.
It didn't need to be rushed.
Bitch, I gave it to you at 10:30 this morning.
Exactly.
I got you.
Exactly. And I'm like, what the fuck? And I had an email from the customer going, hey, you know, I need this kit out tonight. And
this kid?
Kit.
Oh, okay.
Because I deal with hydraulic parts.
Look at that. Right. Son of a bitch.
So,
That's Drake.
Pretty much what happened was that the kit didn't get set up. Sorry, trying to get a train of thought here.
Yeah, what the fuck is going on around here?
I know.
Oh, did it.
So anyway, so
did.
I didn't get the thing set up until later, you know, and I had to rush it through. And he's like, well, why didn't you just tell me that it was a rush? You know, and I was like, well, because I thought that if I gave it to you at 10:30 in the morning, that it would be done by noon.
Right.
You know, and it seems to be the common bullshit around that place, you know. It's just like, oh yeah, I'm gonna pass it to you, and hopefully you get it done when you're supposed to, and you don't. And
passing the heat.
It's not a good McSweeney minute. I don't know. I'm just, you know.
Passing the heat's good.
Passing the heat.
No, it's not passing the heat. It's you need to do your job so I can finish mine. You know, and you didn't finish your job, or do it in a timely manner, so I couldn't get mine done.
So calling somebody out, giving them heat.
I'm trying to.
Oh yeah, it's giving them. I guess. What?
You'll be a dick about it?
No, yeah, I am going to be a dick about it. Yeah, I agree with you a little bit. It does kind of suck for McSweeney.
Well, I mean, because I don't have the power to do, or not the power, but the access to set up these things that he does. So I have to give to him to get that done.
Assholes don't pull their own weight.
Exactly.
Okay.
You know, it's a 2-hour show.
Nobody's gonna listen.
The last time there was a 2-hour show was not.
Whiskey Puss says no one's gonna listen to it. But plenty of people will listen because Whiskey Puss's return was a big deal.
Yeah, Whiskey Puss is the only reason people will listen to the show.
Yeah. And then we had a little taste of the Russian today, and people may want to hear the Russian. Look at her. Make the motion like she's sucking dick.
What was
it's
that?
Bridesmaids.
Yeah, it was from
what
Bridesmaids.
Was,
look, I just showed her this. Bridesmaids, you're a little cunt.
No, yeah, she doesn't go. She goes.
Yeah, but.
She goes. I bet you're the most popular girl in school. She goes. Yeah, I am. And she goes. You're a little cunt.
We have to have them both on next time. So everybody would listen to this show because they wanted to hear the return of Whiskey Puss. Everybody's gonna listen to the next show because they want to hear the Russian comeback.
It was the return of Gayvid too, but nobody cares about that. Fuck him. He just looks assholes all day.
Fuck him right in the asshole.
Is this on?
Yes.
It is on, yeah.
Okay.
I like how she tapped it.
Check one.
This thing on?
So, Whiskey Puss, are you going to be here for the gas return?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Are you really?
I didn't miss it for the world.
Friday, supposedly Friday night.
Friday night?
We're talking about
it. I don't know. I'll
pencil
it in.
Now,
pencil it in.
Now, pencil it in. Good thing pencils have erasers.
Oh, we haven't done a show in 5 weeks. We're doing one.
We're doing two in 3 days. How about that?
Hell yeah. I would love to bigger with it.
But you know what? Yeah. He doesn't pull that kind of weight. Like, it'll just be them. It'll be an intimate CO show, just the two of them.
Yeah, we're going to give simultaneous.
It won't be this big group.
Simultaneous.
Yeah, we're going to give simultaneous mouth hugs.
Mouth hugs, yeah. And then
Whiskey Puss will be in the corner saying, fuck you faggots all day.
She never
clarifies,
but I get it.
Yeah, clearly they're going to be like holding each other.
No, exactly. The whole show's going to be like,
that's what the entire the Whiskey Puss show. What's up? I'm done.
Okay, she just sounded like Snooki right there.
You're about to get slapped, dude.
That's Snooki.
You're about to get slapped.
Snooki is cool as fuck now.
Snooki was always cool.
She's calling for the end.
She's calling for the end.
So,
I right. still have so, a McSweeney to McSweeney.
Yeah, we're still
having a McSweeney minute.
Oh, you already spoke to us a little bit about what yours was all about, and I'm curious to hear the finished product. Go right ahead.
Oh, mine's about my,
guys who don't wrap it up.
I like that conversation.
Yeah, including myself. I'm talking about a, like a, let's say a, I'm sorry?
Uh-huh.
What was that, Peanut?
She's an asshole.
Why is asshole the topic of the night?
Am I the asshole? Because I like people to wrap it up. Whoa.
You are the asshole, if that's the case.
Yeah. Yeah.
If she's all about that,
you're
the
asshole.
Yeah,
you are.
Yeah.
Shit, just go real. Wrap it up.
Which kind of got me in the predicament that I'm in.
Wrap it up, son.
I mean, granted, I do wrap it up, and I offer to wrap it up, but I kind of give her that look like... And then they're like, no, you don't. Oh, thank God.
All right.
No, you don't have to, thank God. All right, I won't.
Is that what you tell Ethan?
All right, it's a two-hour-long show already.
She has been present for like fucking 45 minutes of it.
Yeah, I've taken a lot of breaks.
Go ahead.
Yeah, so much money. Okay, so... So about 5 years ago, I got myself in a child support case.
Oh
no, go ahead.
Ruh-roh. Nobody wants to hear about this.
Yeah, no, I think I've talked about this before. What? But I just found out.
He's just sitting.
I said Barf City.
Barf City chick, Barf City chick.
Am I getting hated on right now? I don't understand.
No, I'm not hating on
you. No, it's fine. No. You sang a whole song, but that's fine.
I know the rest of the song.
Yeah. Okay, then continue. Crickets.
That's
so yeah, I just find out that based on this tranny having other kids, getting married, living somewhere else, if I were to refile, I'm going to have to pay more. And a lot more, too.
Didn't you get married, then you had a kid, then...
No. I had a kid.
Then you got married.
Then I got married. Didn't have a child with that person.
Right.
Then had a child with somebody else, and I'm all over
the tranny? I don't get it.
Wait a minute. I didn't know that.
I did.
Oh,
ding
Jesus
dong.
Christ.
Uh-huh. So...
Cat's out of the bag now.
You cream pie some broad. Then you married another broad.
No,
cream pie, Mary, cream pie, yeah.
Wait, but there's three separate people.
Yeah.
So you cream pie some broad.
Yeah.
Married another broad.
Yeah.
Cream pied a few bitches.
Then cream pied another broad.
And only one got pregnant.
And then...
The intern's...
Wait,
real quick.
The intern's who you're with now.
Yes.
Cream
okay.
No cream pie. All right,
so that's a total of four broads.
Yes.
Okay.
Two kids. One
two kids.
Rich.
Shut up, Peanut.
But you're going like your boy girl in it. So right now.
No, I've been with four girls.
No. But what I mean to say is like you're alternating. Like, you had a kid with one, no kid with the other, a kid with one.
He had a girl and then he had a boy.
No kid.
Right now, with the intern, should be solid. No kid.
Yeah. So
true.
If you play your cards right,
you're gonna have a girl.
Do you see what's going on here?
I see. She's taking the boy girl thing literally. Like if you cream pie the intern, you're gonna have a girl.
No, he's gonna skip the
intern. The next person's gonna be a girl.
Yeah. We're just
anyway, I'm sorry, but
basic math.
No, I mean I mean
it's not basic. It's kind of fucking retarded.
Yeah, it's definitely not basic math.
You probably should.
I probably should what?
Snip your balls.
Oh, so I should get fixed.
And just produce kittens and. Puppies.
Kittens and puppies. So now I need to turn into an animal that produces animals.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then give me the kittens, obviously, because I'm.
And then actually fucking find somebody that you want to be with for the rest
personals.com. What?
You have balls. Uh-huh, show them the video now. It's so annoying.
Finish up before I shoot myself.
I got nothing, no.
No, this is good. This is apparently we have a video. Being the most annoying person. I'll let you put it on the
website. Oh, she'll let us.
This is Val.
Oh, it's you.
This
I thought it was.
Puss.
Okay, I thought it was.
This is the stray cat outside of my house. You have balls. Nobody wants you when you have balls. And nobody else has the balls around you. You have balls. You have balls. You're a good baby. I get very drunk and I love stray kittens. And
is that your cat?
No,
that's the stray cat.
Stray.
And you're wiggling around singing.
Lynx. Siamese cat.
We have to post it. That is hilarious.
That's amazing.
Balls.
You just came off.
I'm very, very embarrassed, but.
That was right off the top of your head.
But he's a human. Yeah, off the top of my drunk ass. Hold my brains up.
Roll him over and pet him again. Lay down. Oh, what a good boy. Look at that asshole.
He has black balls and a black asshole, and he's pure white.
There's a straight cat.
Oh, he has
black
balls.
Like certain breed. I
don't
know. Sounds like my
dad.
He has
got
black balls.
He would fuck your couch up, and you would be
knocked down. An all-white cat with black balls and a black asshole.
You have balls. Nobody wants you when you have balls. No balls here.
So we're not putting that video up there?
No, we have to. We have to.
No, the other. You have
the first one. The first one.
The first one. The first one's going to go up there?
That's hilarious.
That's the new theme song for sure.
That is Whiskey Puss shirt material all day long.
Oh,
there
you go.
Holy shit.
All right, so until.
Felicia.
That was a gem. That was a gem.
Oh, so Whiskey Puss said bye, Felicia.
You have balls.
Can I see that video?
Are we signing off?